following is a presentation of Bounce TV Sports.
Morehouse march toward a conference title is not without obstacles. The hope of putting one rivalry loss behind them is in the balance. Today, Team Unity will be tested as they face their oldest rival in school history. The Golden Tigers of Tuskegee, name equates champions driven to hoist another trophy. Tiger, Tiger, the classic on Bounce, football our way. And it's tailgating, food, family, and of course football at the 78th annual Tuskegee-Morehouse Classic. The Maroon Tigers of Morehouse taking on the Golden Tigers from Tuskegee. And yes, you hear the fans from Tuskegee who have made the trip over to Columbus, Georgia. James Verrett along with Ryan Stewart. Ryan, the fans at home can't smell what we smell, but it smells pretty good out there.
It smells really good. People have been tailgating all night long prior to today's football game, and I'm glad I didn't come in hungry because I'd be in big trouble right now because of the food on the grill.
Well, the crown jewel of this weekend's activity is the football game, 78 years in the making. For Morehouse, a sense of urgency because they had a loss last week against their rival Clark Atlanta, and now their running backs need to step up big if they have a chance to win.
They depend on these running backs. For the last 3 years, they depended on one, and David Carter. This year, Thomas Williams, number 23, will be the guy that is the speedster. He's the smaller of the two running backs, playing through injuries, but he's a track guy, and coach knows he can't run him between the tackles. He'll find ways to isolate him one-on-one in coverage with linebackers. And Sheldon Hamilton, the bigger of the two backs, he's a bruiser, working with a little ACL injury from last year, but he's recovered, getting about 4 yards per carry, 67 yards per game, had a breakout game versus Central last about 2 weeks ago, 165 yards and 3 TDs. He's ready to carry the load, James.
For the reigning SIAC champion Tuskegee Golden Tigers, their linebacking core is outstanding. Chen, Taylor, and Mason, they lead the way.
All three very, very good football players, the strongest section of this defense. Last season, James, 292 tackles collectively. Quavon Taylor, named to first team all SIAC as a freshman, doesn't waste any steps, won't miss any tackles. El Malik Chen, outside linebacker that will be on the line of scrimmage rushing the passer more than anyone else. And Marquise Mason, third in tackles last year, great pad level player when it comes to making contact. These guys are very, very fundamentally sound.
This is a rivalry game. When we come back, we'll have kickoff for 78 years. The Golden Tigers, the Maroon Tigers, the Morehouse Tuskegee Classic. Bounce, football our way.
There are some moments you spend your life preparing for.
Today's game is brought to you by Gillette. Sensitive skin demands precision equipment. Fusion ProGlide is Gillette's number one razor on sensitive skin. And by Toyota, introducing the all-new 2014 next-generation Corolla Toyota. Let's go places! And when you go to the Tuskegee-Morehouse Classic, food is top priority before kickoff. A lot of fans here tailgating, and it looks good. Hopefully they save me some for after the game. And you see, even the Tiger mascot wants a little piece of it. Let's go down to the field with the third member of our broadcast crew, Doug Stewart. Doug?
Thanks, guys. Hey, Tuskegee starting quarterback Justin Nard was injured last week in the win against Fort Valley State. So senior Rashard Burkett will be behind center today. He's a veteran senior quarterback that has played a lot of snaps for the Golden Tigers. So the staff is very comfortable with him behind center. As for Morehouse, they get back sophomore defensive lineman Austin Clark from a concussion. He actually could have went last week, but staff held him out to err on the side of caution. Coach Freeman said, if we had Austin last week, our chances of winning against Clark Atlanta would have been greatly improved. Guys, back to you.
Thanks a lot. You see a shot of Rashard Burkett. He has an opportunity to shine today because Justin Nard is out with an injury. He is not necessarily known as the best passer, but you see the throngs of Tuskegee fans. They are eagerly awaiting to see him perform. This rivalry is the 103rd meeting, the oldest HBCU rivalry in the nation. 78 straight years they have played here in Columbus, Georgia. Tuskegee leads the series with an outstanding 66-29-7 record, Ryan, and they're playing for that right there, the trophy from the Tuskegee-Morehouse Classic. And not only the trophy, it is bragging rights.
Oh my gosh, look at it. Isn't it beautiful? Who wouldn't want to hoist that trophy at the end of this ball game? both teams are going to be fighting for it and trying to get to the title carrier.
And Morehouse won the toss the first of the second half. Hodrick low and Tyree Brooks back deep for Tuskegee, and kicking away for Morehouse, Hector Solis. 78 years in the making. And this one is underway. Lowe will take it at his own 14-yard line, trying to find a hole, has one, gets beyond the 30-yard line. He loses one tackler, but knocked out of bounds at about the 35-yard line. Good run by Lowe.
Relatively short kick, so Lowe got it. Very good field position already. Had a very good block by Tyree Brooks to break him for another 5 or 6 yards. That's a good start for this Tuskegee offense.
And for Tuskegee's offense, Hodrick Lowe, the young man from Atlanta, Georgia, the running back, and Michael Thornton, he's a fullback, but he has hands like a receiver.
They say even though he's a fullback, he can play the tailback position, and he's got the best hands on the team, James.
They're going to go with an offset in the backfield with three wide receivers. Trying to run a little option. They get the low. Low has a huge hole. Goes through it beyond the 40. Sort of paused there for a second, but able to get 8 yards on the gain. Austin Clark, we said his name earlier, already making an impact on the 8-yard gain.
Very good play just now on the pitch. Low kind of read his blocks the wrong way. If he would have turned that play up inside, he may have got a little bit more yards, but you can't complain when you've got about an 8-yard gain.
Second down and two, the Golden Tigers, reigning SIAC champions, already showing that they have a strong rushing attack. Riquette looking to throw, and the ball is tipped, almost intercepted. Good play by number 33, Brian Thomas, for Morehouse, almost had it.
That's one of those plays as a linebacker, you hate to miss it. When the ball hits you right in your hands and you play it perfectly with your drop and everything else, you want to make sure that you secure that catch and get it into your body, and Brian Thomas wasn't able to do that just now. Great drop in coverage, got underneath the curl route of number two. All he needed to do was catch the ball.
Intended for Marquel Gardner, but incomplete. And some action on the line. They give it to Thornton, the big fullback, and he looks like he has enough for the first down. A 4-yard gain by Thornton.
Michael Thornton, somewhat of a throwback. A lot of teams in today's game, in college and in the NFL, James, they're not using fullbacks that often. Well, Tuskegee and Coach Slater, he's not one of those guys. He will utilize his fullback to get those short yardage when it comes to third and two, fourth and one. He'll give them the ball all the time.
And you see his numbers on the season, 3 touchdowns off of 25 attempts, 138 yards. He is the guy that gets the short yardage.
And he had a 5.5-yard average. Why not give him the ball?
And a flag is thrown. Our referee today, Marcus Woods.
Substitution. Offense. 5-yard penalty. First down.
That'll push him back 5 to make it first down and 15. You see Willie Slater, the head coach for Tuskegee, reigning conference champion, definitely does not like to see early mistakes from his offense.
The object is to make yards, I give them away.
Clear pass to Lowe. Lowe gets beyond the 40, past midfield. Good move by Lowe, able to get into Morehouse territory, close to another first down. Lance Bennett, the tackle for Morehouse, 15-yard gain for the Golden Tigers.
Flare passes like that are really just an extension of a run. The quarterback, instead of handing it off, just throws it down the line of scrimmage. And just now, and it's a very good, insightful run by Hodrick Lowe. Did a good job of reading his blocks and getting the ball upfield to secure a first down.
Lowe, a freshman from Atlanta, Georgia, 3 receptions, 40 yards so far this season. He has come in and taken the running back spot after a dynamic performance last year from Derek Washington, whose eligibility is up. Lowe, once again, a huge hole, able to get close to another first down, possibly, we'll call it,
they say 11 yards on the carry. Another first down for the Golden Tigers. Thaddeus Shaw on the tackle.
Who can't get a first down when you've got a hole the size of that? You could have driven a truck through that hole just now. A good tackle by Emmanuel Parks, but it's just so far down the line of scrimmage that it didn't matter.
First and 10, ball on the 32. Rashad Briquette on the option, getting some pressure. Low fumbles the football. Recovery Morehouse. The defense steps up big and makes Tuskegee pay for their mistake. Mitchell DeWalt with the fumble recovery.
Running backs have to remember before they take off to go down the field to secure the pitch first. Good job just now by the quarterback getting the ball in an area where Lowe could catch it. He just didn't look it all the way in. May have heard those footsteps coming towards him, James.
And that was Brian Thomas on the fumble recovery. Good job by Brian Thomas and also DeWalt. First and 10, and now we'll take a look at Morehouse's offense, but a flag is thrown.
Malik McGuffey a little eager to get
offense,
started.
Number 9, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Redshirt freshman McGuffey from McDonough, Georgia.
Coaches used to say, hold your water, don't let it go.
And he didn't hold long enough. First down 15. Johnson looking to throw, finds Cox the receiver. Flag is thrown, possibly a hold on McGuffey. This may be all coming back. And McGuffey, his lake is receding in Lake McGuffey.
Offense, number 9, 10-yard penalty, still first down.
Now he needs to report to the coach to talk about a few things. Two penalties, two consecutive plays, not giving the offense a chance to advance down the field at all.
And you see the impact players for the Golden Tigers, Quavon Taylor and El Malik Chen. Two of the three linebackers who make huge impacts. Last year, they combined, the threesome had 292 tackles. First and forever for Morehouse. They'll call it 25 yards for a first down. Johnson with some time, getting pressure now, will try to run it, and he is brought down by Kevdrick Blue for the Golden Tigers.
Johnson made a very smart decision just now. He's not going to throw the ball away. Had time in the pocket from the protection, but he just didn't see anybody open down the field. Decided to keep it and go as far as he could. He got the ball back to the line of scrimmage.
Monquavius Johnson, the true freshman from Decatur, Georgia, he is nursing a sore ankle. Did not start last week, but did finish the game in the loss against Clark Atlanta. Second down, 25. Long throw and catch. Threw across the body, but able to get back to the original line of scrimmage. Devon Mann, the leading receiver for Morehouse, getting only his second catch in the last 2 weeks. Travis Lee on the tackle, 11-yard gain.
Quick comeback route ran by Devon Mann just now, and he sprinted up the field, pushed the DBs off, made a quick stop, and Johnson had the ball right there waiting for him on his turn.
Third down conversions last week, 0-for-12, 32% on the season. Huge play. Johnson getting some pressure, and he is brought down. Big sack. Good play, number 55, Reginald Woods, his fifth sack of the season, the senior from Compton, California. 5-yard loss, punting situation for the Maroon Tigers.
When it's third and long, your defensive ends will just peel their ears back and go. A little push-shove move right now by 55, turned the corner and got to the quarterback. That's a good blitz.
Good play by Woods. Back deep is Monquel Gardner, and punting to Mateo Agoro, one of the top punters in the SIAC. Blocked! Recovered by Tuskegee. Touchdown, Golden Tigers. Special team stepped up big. Travis Lee with the block and the score.
Khalif Williams did a very good job of coming in there. He really was untouched. Laid out for the ball and got it. And Travis Lee did the ultimate scoop and score. It looks a little bit easy, but it's not. Picking that ball up and getting to the end zone. He was untouched. Williams was untouched. And Travis Lee was there for the charity.
Good job by Travis Lee and the special team, point after attempt. And it is wide left. Trevor Wiley, the freshman from Douglasville. And now the Golden Tigers, not offense, defense, but special teams get on the board first. 78 years, Morehouse Tuskegee Classic, HBCU football on Bounce. Welcome back to Columbus, Georgia. Tuskegee with a 6-0 lead, 9:30 left to play in the first quarter. My Crazy Roommate, the original from Martin, the creator of the Jamie Foxx Show, comes an original new series. Don't miss the premiere of My Crazy Roommate Monday, 10 p.m. Eastern, 9 Central, only on Bounce.
Special teams, a big third of the game. A lot of people overlook that from time to time. They concentrate on offense and defense. As you see how important special teams is, because that allowed Tuskegee to get on the board first.
T.J. Williams will take it at his own five, trying to match another special team play, but slips and falls at about the 20-yard line, 15-yard return for T.J. Williams. Let's take another look at that special teams play by the Golden Tigers of Tuskegee.
It's a third of the game coming off the corner. Very good job. Didn't even have to lay out for it. Williams makes the play, and Travis Lee scoops it up, gets to the end zone. Got to do a better job of fanning out when you are the end on the punt team.
Going to give to Shelton Hamilton, and he may have gained a half a yard. Good defensive play by Tuskegee, Brandon Dorsey, leading the way for the Golden Tigers. Now for Morehouse, how do you bounce back after special teams basically failed you on the last series?
Coaches got to tell his guys to ignore what just happened. Let's put the offense back on the field, try to establish some type of successful drive to get some points. Even if they don't get any points, if you can get the ball down the field with an established offensive drive, it'll help heal the pain just a little bit.
Monquavius throws to T.J. Williams, the speedster, able to get some positive yards. Travis Lee on the tackle for the Golden Tigers. Williams is still banged up from last week's Clark Atlanta game, according to Coach Doug Freeman, and now they're just trying to get him back up to speed.
Yeah, he's playing through a little bit of injuries, James, but he's a tough guy. A little slight in size, but he's got a lot of heart, and we'll see that throughout the course of today's ball game.
Third and four, high snap. They give it to Hamilton, and Hamilton is met by a wall, but breaks through, able to get maybe one, possibly 2 yards, but once again tackled. Reginald Woods there for Tuskegee to make the play.
Sheldon Hamilton not as fast as he used to be since dealing with an ACL surgery last season, but he's a guy that keeps his legs moving, and he's a 230-pound back. That's a heavy load. Look at him right there, refusing to go down, shaking people off of him, and just trying to get as much yards as possible. Real hard, tough run.
Timoteo Ogoro, you see his numbers, his long of the year, 51. He needs a boomer right now, punting from his own 14. And he's going to fake the punt. Ogoro, he has track speed. First down and more. Past midfield, inside the 40, down to the 30. Great call by Morehouse.
Excellent call by Coach Freeman just now. What does he have to lose after his team gives up a punt, gets blocked, and they give up a score to Tuskegee? And you mentioned it. Ogoro is one of the better athletes on the football field for Morehouse, and he is extremely fast, as we saw that just now, with his speed around the corner.
41 yards on this gain. They call him the fastest person on campus. He runs the 100 meters on track, And, oh, by the way, he's also a punter and plays defense.
A lot of people don't respect punters on football fields, but Agoro deserves respect from his own team as well as the opposition.
And just like in any special game, in a classic, you're always going to see special plays, and that's one of them.
Now that was a great call by Coach Freeman right now. What does he have to lose coming off of a loss to his rival school last year in Clark and now playing one of the better teams that won the SIAC last year in Tuskegee? Go for it all, James. Put it all on the table.
And right now, Coach pushes the pause button because they may have had too many people on the field. Timeout, Morehouse. And for Coach Slater, he's trying to ponder to see what defense he can conjure up to stop the special plays by Morehouse. HBCU football on Bounce. Welcome back to HBCU football on Bounce. Tuskegee with a 6-0 lead in the first quarter. It's the battle for the throne. The 2013 SIAC football championship is Saturday, November 16th at 7 p.m. at Lakewood Stadium in Atlanta. Experience the excitement as champions of the East and West divisions meet to kick off the 100th anniversary of the SIAC. Purchase your tickets in advance. For more information on the SIAC championship, visit thesiac.com to buy your tickets. And we will also be there if you can't make it in person right here on Bounce. First and 10 from the 30-yard line. They're going to get fumble on the play. Lineman picks it up, another fumble. And it's Tuskegee with the ultimate recovery, and they get the ball back.
A lot of minimal mistakes being made right now by Morehouse. The Maroon Tigers there beating themselves early in this ball game.
Keith Trumps with the fumble recovery after two people had a chance at it.
Big Richard Washington, the left tackle, almost scooped it up, but that's not a big man's job, James. He's not going to be able to pick that ball up. Just never really got the ball in the breadbasket to hold on to it. Gave it away to Tuskegee.
All he had to do was fall on the football.
Big Richard would be a star. Does.
First and 10 for the Golden Tigers. Rashad Briquet back to throw, getting some pressure, looking for a receiver, and throws incomplete. Good pressure there by Richard Sanders for Morehouse.
Briquet was ready for the comeback just now by his wide receiver. Took a little bit longer than he thought. That's why he ended up throwing the ball out of bounds.
Rashad Briquet is the backup quarterback. Their starter, Justin Nard, is out with an injury. Got hurt last week against Fort Valley State in the win.
That's a tough play for a quarterback when you're rolling out to your right like that and you're trying to make a completion on a deep comeback route. And it doesn't help that you've got a few people hounding you from Morehouse's defense.
Second down and 10. Looking to throw, getting some pressure, finds low. He has the ball, but then drops it as he turns his head.
Tried to run a little slip screen just now. Had a bunch formation at the top of the screen. You would think that the pass play was going to be attempted to one of the guys in the bunch formation, but it didn't happen. They tried to throw it to the running back.
So far, the offense for the Golden Tigers looked like rushing the football. They were in sync. But throwing the football, they still have some things they need to work out.
It would have been a little bit different if Justin Nard was in, but he's not, and Burkett's trying to find his way right now.
Burkett on third, getting a lot of pressure from the Morehouse defense. He eludes three defenders, throwing it long, has a receiver. Catch is made, first down, Golden Tigers. Good reception made by number four, Caleb Williams, the reserve wide receiver who has made big plays for the Golden Tigers.
Think about it. Already in today's ball game, Caleb Williams has blocked a punt, and now he's saved the Tuskegee Golden Tigers with a long pass catch down the sideline. Wide open by himself, no defender in sight.
Not bad for the junior from Sarasota, Florida. First and 10 after the 40-yard gain inside the 40 of Morehouse. Give to Lowe, breaks one tackle, and able to get about 5 yards on the game. Call it six to make it second down and four.
Regular lead play by Lowe just now, following the fullback through the hole. Got a very good positive game. Just about 6 yards on the carry.
Play game, 6 yards, second down, four.
They're gonna go with the I formation. Sending Gardner in motion. Give to Lowe, huge hole. Goes to the outside, trying to outrun the defender, and does. Touchdown Lowe, touchdown Golden Tigers. 29-yard touchdown run, Hardrick Lowe.
Check out the block by number 20, Joshua Crow, cutting down the linebacker to allow Lowe to bounce outside of him. Very good design play, a simple lead. Fullback does his job by picking up a blocker right through the hole, and Lowe does the rest by bouncing the ball to the outside. That's one thing about Coach Slater and the Tuskegee Golden Tigers. They're going to establish the line of scrimmage and try to beat you down physically.
Point after attempt by Trevor Wiley is good, and Hardrick Lowe with the long run, able to expand the lead in the 78th annual Tuskegee-Morehouse Classic. 13-0 is your score. We'll be right back on Bounce.
They say it was...
He says.
You're watching HBCU football on Bounce. Football our way. And so far, it's been Hardrick Lowe's way. 5 carries, 51 yards, 1 touchdown. Not bad for the freshman from Atlanta, Georgia, Ryan.
Very good start to the day for Mr. Lowe. He's a guy that's got exceptional speed, and if you don't get your hands on him as he approaches that line of scrimmage, he could make you pay, as he's done so far today.
Wiley to kick back deep for Tuskegee, Williams and Thurston. Thurston will take it inside his 10, has a huge hole, and is knocked down at about the 35-yard line. Good open field tackle made by 35, Asim Manuel, 26-yard return. Let's take one more look at that touchdown by Lowe.
Yeah, you see the fullback come through the line of scrimmage and take out the linebacker, and that allows Lowe to get to the outside, and no one's in position to make a play in the secondary. He bounces it outside to the end zone.
Safety help.
You've got to be filling the holes when your linebackers are not in play like they weren't just now.
26 seconds. Trailing by 13. Monquavius Johnson, the true freshman from Decatur, has to step up big. Johnson looking to throw and leads his receiver a little bit too much. Sean Moore, the intended receiver, the young man from Adrian, Georgia.
Devon Mann did a good job of getting the block out there for the screen for Sean Moore, but he's got to catch the ball before he can turn it upfield.
And for Monquavius Johnson, for fans who have just tuned in to watch Morehouse, he won the job as a true freshman on an athletic and academic scholarship, one of the smartest guys on the team, but so far been suffering from an ankle injury. Shelton Hamilton with a 5-yard gain. El Malik Chen there on the tackle for Tuskegee. Ryan, at this point, do you just say we need to abandon the run and start to pass the ball every down?
Way too early to abandon anything yet. We're still in the first quarter. You still got time to get those linemen settled and get your backs out there in the field.
And Johnson with a nice throw and catch to Cox, but he pays the price enough for a first down for Morehouse into the Golden Tiger territory. 16-yard gain for Cox.
Jacoby Browder made a very good tackle in the open field just now on Cox. Lowered his pad level, got his head across the bow, and laid the hammer down.
They're going to stay with 4 wide receivers, 3 to the far side. Johnson looking to throw, getting some pressure, and finds the 2 guys, but Don Cox able to make the good catch. Another first down for Morehouse, 18-yard gain.
And like you said, there were 2 guys in the area that could have caught that ball just now.
Now the defense for Tuskegee has to stiffen. This is the furthest Morehouse has gone into Golden Tiger territory. Johnson with some time. Eludes one defender. Nice shuttle pass. and able to turn a negative into a positive. Once again, his favorite receiver on this drive, Don Cox, for a 7-yard gain.
What Morehouse is doing right now with the four wide receivers in the field, they're spreading out the defense and the linebackers, which are the core of the Tuskegee defense. And then you're making Johnson pick and choose if he's going to run the ball or even do a little shuttle pass like he did just now to number 18.
Before today's game, Don Cox only had 5 receptions. He's already got a few on this drive. Good strong run by number 21, Shelton Hamilton, the young man from Montgomery, Alabama, on a 3-yard gain. Close to another first down for the Maroon Tigers of Morehouse, Reginald Woods on the tackle.
Shelton Hamilton did a very good job just now of making the first guy miss. He was still behind his line of scrimmage. You've got to make those first guys miss so you can get positive yards as you get to the line of scrimmage.
For Tuskegee, they are ranked number 1 in the SIAC in scoring defense. They bend, but they definitely don't break when it's money time. First and 10, ball placed at the 11-yard line. Johnson. And he eludes one defender, but then eventually brought down. Good play by Aaron Bennett, the young man from Hinesville, Georgia.
With the number of Bennett's on the defense for the Golden Tigers, we'll probably end up hearing that name said quite often today. Johnson stepped back in the pocket, avoids getting a sack, breaks away, and then Bennett brings him down. Bent that leg a little awkwardly just now.
Aaron Bennett has two brothers who are also Golden Tigers. This is the 8th play of the drive. Hamilton on the run, able to get some yardage. Down to about the 6-yard line, maybe 3 or 4 yards short of a first. They can get a first down before they can get a touchdown on this drive.
Somewhat of a read option for Montquavius Johnson just now. He saw that Hamilton had a little bit more daylight than he did. If he would have kept it, gave it away, and Hamilton got the positive gain.
You see Montquavius numbers, 3 for 4, 41 yards. One of the reasons why he's a starting quarterback as a true freshman. Johnson with some time. Throw a little bit too hard. Pass intended for Sean Moore.
Threw the ball a little bit behind Sean Moore just now. If he would have put the ball on his numbers or in front of him, probably would have been a better job. Trips formation, wide open. Look who's standing right there, Devon Mann. Montquavius didn't see him.
And now a chip shot field goal. 23-yard kick for Hector Solis. Kick is up. And it is good. 1:48 left to play, and it is now a 10-point game, 13-3. Off of the Hector Solis chip shot field goal.
Special teams wise, Morehouse has to do a better job of protecting when it comes to punts and field goals. Almost had a guy come outside just now on the field goal block team to block that field goal.
Rich Freeman obviously happy that his team has shown some resolve. You see his numbers on his career, 7th season at Morehouse, 41-25, one of the most successful coaches in Morehouse history. He's won an SIAC championship, gone to the Division II playoffs, first time in school history under Freeman's tutelage.
He's a good coach, dealing with a lot of youth right now on his ball club, and he's also dealing with a lot of guys that are banged up and playing through injuries. But he's a guy that's a motivator, and he'll bring his guys to the field and have them ready to play tough ball.
And you see Coach Slater, obviously his defense did what they had to do. They bent, but they did not break and give up a touchdown.
You always take that 3 over 6, James. Coach Slater, real tough, hard-nosed coach, and that's how his football players play. They try to establish a line of scrimmage offensively and defensively up front, and they do a good job of pounding the football with their running backs.
And back deep, low, along with Brooks for the Golden Tigers. Solis with the kick. Low takes it at his own 15. Low finds a hole on the outside and is tripped up but knocked down at about the 40. Good return. Joshua Thurston on the tackle. 25-yard return on Hodrick Lowe.
I mean, if I can get 25 yards per play or when it comes to a return, I'll take it all day long. Happy to have Thurston there just now.
Mitch.
Now it's first down and 10 at the 37.
Another carry for the fullback, but this time the interior defensive lineman did a good job of holding the point of attack and not giving away any ground for there to be any yards gained on the carry.
Time is running out in the first quarter, and you see a block punt for a touchdown and also a run for a touchdown. You see Tuskegee doing the job, special teams and also on offense. Second down and 10. Burkett with the throw and catch for Gardner. And now we've got flags throwing. A helmet comes off. Joshua Thurston, one of the scrappy defensive backs, able to stop Gardner after a 14-yard gain. And you see the stiff arm right there, and that's not what you want to do with the stiff arm by Gardner. Talk to our referee, Marcus Woods.
So the play is a first down. You got personal foul, face mask, offense. Number two, we're going to go back, 15-yard penalty, first and 10.
And some of the Tuskegee fans do not like that, but it is a face mask.
Players, James, you've got to protect the players. You can't have their face mask getting pulled to the point where helmets can come off. It's very, very dangerous.
Monquel Gardner a little bit too aggressive, and now they're having a discussion between the referees trying to make sure that they get the call right.
Number 33, Brian Thomas, in there like he's one of the referees.
Correction. There are fouls by both teams on the play. Personal foul, face mask, offense. Number two, personal foul, defense, face mask. Number four, those penalties were offset. We'll replay second down.
And seems as though both offender and defender both touching face mask.
Yeah, ooh, that's dangerous. That's definitely dangerous. And the offender typically can use a stiff arm to the face mask as long as he doesn't grip his face mask with his fingers and he pushes with his hand. But the defender, he can't ever touch that helmet area.
Joshua Thurston, the defender on the play for Morehouse College, Monquel Gardner, the offensive receiver, both called for penalties, and they'll replay second down. Less than a minute to play in the first quarter. 13-3 is your score in favor of the Golden Tigers from Tuskegee. Pitch out to Tyree Brooks, and he may have gained one, possibly 2 yards. Thaddeus Shaw in on the tackle for the Maroon Tigers of Morehouse.
Regular simple pitch where you're allowing the tailback to decide if he's going to go off of the fullback that's blocking for him as a lead blocker or if he's going to go off of the tackle. Wasn't too much of a game.
Rashard Burkett, young man from Montgomery, Alabama, by way of Garden City Community College, a senior for Tuskegee, getting an opportunity to shine. He did start a few games last year before Justin Nard came in and became the permanent starter. And that will end the first quarter. Great first quarter for 78 years consecutively, Tuskegee Golden Tigers and Morehouse, but special teams is the difference in this game as Tuskegee has a 13-3 lead. HBCU football on Bounce.
Eddie Murphy.
Well, welcome back to HBCU football on Bounce. Tuskegee with a 13-3 lead over the Morehouse Maroon Tigers. Let's go down to Doug Stewart, has more on Tuskegee's family approach to football.
Yeah, I heard you guys talk a little bit earlier about the Bennett brothers. A very cool story coming out of Tuskegee is those Bennett brothers, Treyer, Aaron, and Jovan. They hail from Liberty High in Hinesville, Georgia. They're all defensive linemen, and they're all monsters. You know, once in a while, you'll find a pair of brothers like the Manning brothers doing big things in football, or even the Bailey brothers from the University of Georgia, but Tuskegee has done the research, and the results are in. The Bennett brothers are the only three brothers that play for the same team at the same time in college football in America. I asked Treyer, what was it like at the dinner table growing up, and he simply said, it's a war. Back to you guys.
I can imagine. And mom and dad, mama and daddy Bennett are right there. And you can't see the back of their shirts, but it says Bennett. And they're definitely happy to see all three of their children getting a college education. There they are.
Exactly.
See the three names right there.
Right. 79, 97, and 71. That's an incredible story. I can't imagine dinner at the Bennett household.
First, third down and eight. Burkett looking to throw, finds a receiver, Larry Cobb with the reception, enough for the first down, the young man from Demopolis, Alabama, 13-yard gain.
When it comes to coming back to the football, that's what you want your receivers to do right there. You've got to fight downhill like Larry Cobb just did to catch that football. Good block by the fullback to keep his quarterback clean. Good throw, and Cobb came back so hard to make that catch, and it's very, very, very good play.
They're in Morehouse territory. And a huge hole. Nice long run by Chris Anderson, the transfer from Troy University, the 5'9", 190 senior. And Emmanuel Parks makes a touchdown-saving tackle after the 20-yard gain.
Very nice play where you're getting a lot of effort coming straight downhill. The hole was there. Offensive guards, offensive tackles had the defensive line and linebackers blocked out just now. And a very good game for the Tuskegee Golden Tigers.
You see the numbers for Anderson on the season. That's their third play of 20 yards or more today. Once again, gives to Anderson, trying to find a hole, but he is quickly wrapped up. Good open field tackle made by Emmanuel Parks.
Another play by Emmanuel Parks where he kind of fits and replaces from the fullback so he doesn't get blocked, jumps behind him once he moves on and makes the play. It's two consecutive plays for Emmanuel Park right there for the Morehouse defense.
When you have Anderson, who can sub in for Lowe, who's their starter as a true freshman, three plays of 20 yards or more, not bad. Going out of the eye, gets to the fullback. Thurston has a huge hole. 10-5, touchdown, Michael Thornton. The huge play, 26-yard touchdown run for the Golden Tigers.
And James, we talked about how Michael Thornton's got good hands when it comes to being a receiver. Just now, we saw the fullback utilize his vision as well as his speed to get to the end zone. Straight up the middle, right outside the guard, inside the guard and tackle, that is. And he's so fast that the secondary couldn't get to him. Long plays like that is why that fullback has a 5.5-yard average when it comes to carrying the ball for the Golden Tigers.
His fourth touchdown of the season, born after attempt by Trevor Wiley. Wiley's kick is blocked! Morehouse can score two! Knocked out of bounds. Good play, blocked by Austin Clark, returned by Joshua Anderson.
Right in the middle, you want your big guys to come through as much as he can. 52 just jumps to make the play, gets his hands up, and blocks the field goal. It's caught by Morehouse, but no points on the play.
And so far, special teams have played big. 19-3 is your score. Even the homecoming court is happy for Tuskegee.
Today's game is brought to you by Gillette. Sensitive skin demands precision equipment. Fusion ProGlide is Gillette's number one razor on sensitive skin. And by Toyota. Introducing the all-new 2014 next-generation Corolla Toyota. Let's go places.
And you see the extent of tailgating. They got a whole tent out there, tables, chairs, and a lot of food. And I know Mr. Thornton would like to get a little bit of it after the game, but he's gobbling up yardage and scores with his fourth score of the season. Michael Thornton, the young man.
That's unheard of for a fullback. That's unheard of for a fullback to get the ball that often in an offense these days.
Now we'll see if Morehouse can answer. T.J. Williams trying to find a hole, but the quick defense by the Golden Tigers of Tuskegee. Keith Trump's on the tackle,
and
22 yards, and now we've got a little skirmish. Remember, 78 years, you're going to have a little bad luck.
Yeah, these guys don't like each other on a beautiful Sunday afternoon in Columbus. It's hot out there. You know, you want to show some aggression, and from time to time, you got to push each other around to kind of get a little bit of the extra stuff out of your system.
And I think they'll have to burn off that extra aggression on the sideline. Marcus Woods, our head referee, will make the official call.
There are fouls by both teams on the play. After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct on the kicking team, on the return team, number 35. Unsportsmanlike conduct on the kicking team, number 37. Those penalties are offset. First down.
Both young men will definitely have to take some time to cool off after they mixed it up a little bit.
And Sim Manuel and Joshua Austin got a little testy. It's okay, it's football. No harm, no foul, other than the flag that was thrown. Apparently the ball has been spotted in the wrong area because the return was not to the 45-yard line.
They spot where the fight was. That's what happened. And Rich Freeman does not like to see his team play undisciplined, but he wants them to play with emotion.
Right. He wants them to play with emotion. He wants them to play with feeling. But as you said, undisciplined is something that he doesn't want.
Coach Freeman has only defeated Tuskegee once in his time at Morehouse. First and 10, ball is at the 26-yard line. Johnson getting some pressure, gets back to the line of scrimmage, and Aaron Bennett right there to make the big play, but a flag holding against Morehouse.
I think what we're seeing from Montquavious Johnson right now is him fighting through the pain for his team.
Offense, number 21, 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Replay, first down.
Yeah, just now you can see Sheldon Hamilton take his man down with his hands, and that's not good. And again, Montquavious Johnson is doing the best that he can, but he's really not putting a lot of pressure on that ankle, James.
They do have a backup quarterback in Joshua Harris, who has seen spot time, played in a few games for Morehouse. We may see him this afternoon. Sheldon Hamilton gets close, but nowhere close to the yardage needed for a first down. Marquette's Mason on the tackle.
Got Big Richard Washington in the mix just now with a little pushing match after the play. You better be careful and stay away from Big Rich. He's well respected out there, one of the biggest guys on the football field right now.
Talking about a 6'9", 330-pound junior, number 74, Richard Washington. You see the total yards. Tuskegee points off turnovers, 13-0 for Morehouse. Johnson looking to throw. Ball is tipped, almost intercepted. Good play by number 33, El Malik Chin. We talked about the trio of linebackers. El Malik, one of the leaders of that trio.
And Chin is very comfortable in coverage for the Tuskegee Golden Tigers when it comes to the linebacker position. Did a very good job of getting good depth in his drop, getting underneath the number one receiver, which is where you want your linebacker on the defense like that. And he taps the ball in the air, almost made a catch.
Third down. Morehouse is 1-for-4 on third down conversions this afternoon. trying to go for it all long, almost intercepted, touches the hands of Ahmad Muhammad, the young man from Birmingham. He's a freshman. We'll call it a freshman mistake.
You still can't make that mistake. I was taught at a young age, when you touch the football, you have to catch it. And just now, Ahmad Muhammad drops a free gift from Monquavius Johnson. He did a good job of securing the ball at the highest point, or trying to catch it at his highest point. Just couldn't hold on to it.
We did have a flag. It was declined. And it will be a punting situation for Morehouse.
Morehouse playing some sloppy football so far in this first half, James.
Ogoro to punt. And this one is high. Gardner will fair catch and take it in Morehouse territory at about the 49-yard line. 29-yard punt by Ogoro. And it's Tuskegee. Their ground attack has been deadly. Long runs, 19-3 is your score. Golden.
Listen, baby. Detroit is all about the sound.
I'm with the president of Tuskegee University, Dr. Gilbert Roshan. Dr. Roshan, tell us a little bit about the hype that surrounds this game. This is the 78th year of the Tuskegee-Morehouse Classic. What does it mean to your fan base?
We're excited about the prospect every year. I've only been in office for 3 years, starting next month, but it's clear that this legacy has been going on for several of my predecessors, and we look forward to the opportunity, largely because at Tuskegee and at Morehouse, we're in the business of producing scholar athletes in that order, and we're absolutely committed to making this work for our mutual benefit.
Festivus atmosphere before the game. Talk a little bit about the tailgating. Did you have any barbecue?
Not yet. But we saw a tremendous amount of entrepreneurial activity, and it's quite clear that this game not only means something for the players and for the fan base, but also for the economic development of the community.
The president of Tuskegee University, Dr. Gilbert Roshan. Thank you, Doc.
Thanks a lot, Doug and Dr. Roshan. I hope when he said entrepreneurial activity, he wasn't meaning people were trying to sell barbecue plates.
Number 74.
Give that stuff away.
That's what it sounded like to me. They're out tailgating but hustling at the same time.
That's sort of a strange hustle. If everybody's barbecuing, why pay for it?
There's a few people that came that didn't have their grills with them, James.
That's true.
Like me and you, I would have bought a plate.
I think I would have held out. Somebody would have given me some scraps. That's all I need, just a little scraps. First down after the penalty, they move them back 5 yards, back into Tuskegee territory. That's where the Golden Tigers will start. First and 15, 44, 11:33 left to play. Ball's on the 46. Give it to their fullback, Joshua Crow, who has had some spot duty, and he goes nowhere fast. And you see the history of Tuskegee, founded by Booker T. Washington, and you see George Washington Carver, one of their famous alumni, along with Lewis Adams, founded in 1881. Enrollment a little bit over 3,000 students, and a lot of people know within the same town is the place where the Tuskegee Airmen were trained.
A lot of history in that area with this school.
Second down. Crow lost a yard. Second down and 16. Pitch out to Brooks, and Brooks gets most of the negative yards back, close too possible, but a referee says his knee went down at about the 47-yard line, so what we thought was a 5-yard gain ends up only being a 2-yard gain.
What I like about Tuskegee and the Golden Tigers offense is they established a line of scrimmage. They have two backs, one tight end, two wide receivers, and they're going to use their fullback as a lead blocker, coming someplace in between those tackles, and that's what they do. They're not trying to run a lot of options and hide the ball. They're showing you what they're going to do, and they're running the ball downhill.
Third and long, staying in the eye. Fumble on the play. Burkett has it, will throw, and overthrows his intended receiver, Monquel Franklin.
He had Franklin wide open out there with the DB Dean, Joshua Anderson, about 5 yards away, but kind of lost his timing with the pattern when the ball was dropped between the center and the quarterback exchange.
First three and out for Tuskegee this afternoon. Back deep, T.J. Williams, and the punter, Derek James, for Tuskegee. And he gets a pretty good punt off. Williams with a fair catch. Fumble the football, but Morehouse is able to recover. You got to catch it if you're going to fair catch.
Very sloppy football by Morehouse so far in his game, but you know, the punter of Tuskegee did a good job just now securing the snap that was a little bit high. Caught the ball, brought it down, and still got the punt off. Morehouse just having a hard time holding on to the ball today.
Eddie Murphy and Robert De Niro discover that keeping it real ain't that easy. In Showtime, Sunday night at 7 p.m. Eastern, 6 Central, only on Bounce TV. First and 10 for the Maroon Tigers at their own 16. New quarterback in Jordan Tarver, and that play almost went in favor of Tuskegee.
Great play just now by Tyron Thurman when it comes to a DB being out there on an island, pushing through the blocker to get to the play. That's a very aggressive play by the corner.
We've only had spot play by redshirt freshman Jordan Tarver. He was the third option when you think about quarterbacks. Monquavius Johnson, the starter, Joshua Harris, second team, and Tarver, third team. Right now they're going to give to their only back, Shelton Hamilton, who's able to get some positive yards, 7 yard gain. Marquess Mason with the tackle.
And you talk about the backup in there, Jordan Tarver. The way Monquavius Johnson was limping around back there, James, you've got to put the ball in the hands of someone that's comfortable on their ankle, and that wasn't Monquavius Johnson.
And Hamilton comfortable going through the hole, enough for a Maroon Tiger first down, another 7 yard gain by the young man from Montgomery, Alabama. Xavier Briggs on the tackle for Tuskegee.
Again, Morehouse doing a good job with the four wide receiver of spreading the defense of Tuskegee out, so those incredible linebackers that they have to run to make plays.
Sean Moore on the reception, and that's not a catch you want to make, because instead of having a 3 yard gain, he takes a 3, possibly 4 yard loss.
Coaches tell players all the time to know where you are on the field. If Sean Moore would have known where he was just now, he wouldn't have caught that pass to bring it as a loss for his team.
-4, throwing catch from Tarver to Moore. And looks like we have an official timeout.
Official want to make sure that the first down marker is in the right place. If that was a catch, it should be at a 4 yard loss instead of showing first and 10.
Operator, the rule on the play is it was a backward pass. Clock operator, please put 8:40 on the clock. Thank you.
And because it was a backwards pass, that means that the clock continues to run.
Yeah, clearly this ball is thrown behind the line of scrimmage and it's caught. And Sean Moore fell to the ground after the catch. Hence the loss.
Second down, 14. Tarver finds a receiver, catch made. Sean Moore, this time for positive yards.
Right. Very good play by Tarver just now. Staying in the pocket, making sure that he stepped up into the pocket before throwing the ball to his receiver for the positive gain.
11-yard gain. Hamilton trying to get close to a first down. Depending on where they have the spot, he is very close to the 39-yard line. That's where he needs to go. Terrence Leatherwood on the tackle, the young man from Northport, Alabama.
Hard to move the line of scrimmage on Tuskegee between the tackles. They're very sound up front in the linebacking core. They don't make many mistakes.
and gets a favorable spot. First and 10 for the Maroon Tigers. They move the chains. Tarver so far been able to manage this offense fairly well.
Look how wide open number two is there at the bottom of the screen.
Finds Hamilton in the flats, able to rush his way forward, close to another Morehouse first down. Marquess Mason once again there to push him out of bounds. They will mark him out of bounds right after he got a 7-yard gain. They'll call it second and three.
Even though the Maroon Tigers are going three wide and four wide, Tuskegee's decided not to bring in nickel personnel, and they're still letting their linebackers play the defense.
Tarver, throw, catch made. Good play by Don Cox, and once again, Cox showing that he has some pretty good hands.
And here again, Donald Cox was lined up in the number two position at the bottom of the screen, and there's a linebacker out there trying to cover him, and that's not good.
But there was a flag all the way back at the 39-yard line, and it looks like it's coming all the way back.
Every time Morehouse does something positive, they turn around and consequently do something to cost them.
Holding. Offense, number 74, 10-yard penalty from the previous spot, second down.
And that's big Richard Washington, stands 6'9", 330.
Yeah, Rich wasn't able to get that outside foot across the body of the defensive end coming up the field, so he used his hands to protect his quarterback.
So instead of first down, it's second down and 13. Throw to Marcus Alford. He is knocked out of bounds. Gets a 3-yard gain. Travis Lee there to push him out of there.
Good tackle by Travis Lee. When you're a defender like that and you've got an offensive player that's so close to the sideline, use that sideline as if it's one of your very own defenders and push those guys out.
Third down and 10. Jordan Tarver came in for Marquavius Johnson, who was starter of today's game. Tarver getting a long look by head coach Rich Freeman. Throw and catch to Cox. Cox trying to get enough for the first down, but he is short. Quavon Taylor right there to make the tackle, but not before a 6-yard gain. Short of a first down, punting situation for Morehouse.
Quavon Taylor and Kedrick Blue hadn't had a lot of action so far today, so when they got an opportunity just now to make some plays, they dropped the hammer.
And Coach Slater said he wanted to see Quavon be a little bit more physical. We had a chance to talk to him earlier this week. Gardner back deep for Tuskegee, and Ogoro's punt will take a Tuskegee bounce, and it is stopped dead at the 31-yard line. 5:38 left to play, 23-yard punt by Ogoro. 19-3 is your score. HBCU football on bounce.
Now anyone can feel like royalty.
Welcome back to HBCU football on bounce. You know, when you want to drive, you always want to do it in style. And it's time for the Chrysler 300 Motown Edition Great Drive of the Half. And it was five plays, 75 yards, a minute 26, capped off by Hodrick Lowe's 29-yard touchdown run to make it 13-0 in favor of the Golden Tigers. Our Motown edition Chrysler 300 Great Drive of the Half.
A lot of fullback play, as we saw on the drive just now. Fullback opened the hole up for Mr. Lowe.
Put a little bit too much mustard on it. Tyree Brooks, the intended receiver.
One of those plays where the receiver, or number 27, Tyree Brooks, would have liked to get another step or two before the ball came, but due to pressure on the quarterback, he let it go a little bit early.
Number So far, so good for Rashard Burkett. He is in for the injured Justin Nard, who is their regular starter. Burkett and Nard have been battling for the last 2 years for the starting position, won by Nard midway through last season.
In today's game, you need two good quarterbacks and two good running backs.
Burkett, nice throw and catch. Good catch made by Caleb Williams. Young man from Sarasota, Florida, Eric Robinson pushing him out of bounds, 17-yard gain.
Somewhat of a timing route right there. Took a quick three-step drop, allowed his receiver to make his break and threw it to a spot on the field. And Caleb did a good job of making the catch.
Close to midfield. First and 10, ball spotted at the 47-yard line.
Offenses today run a lot of timing routes where they throw the ball to a spot instead of to the man.
Out of the shotgun, Burkett getting some pressure. He takes a huge hit, looking for a receiver, but out of bounds. Larry Cobb, the intended receiver. And fans are looking for flags everywhere, but no flag. Joshua Thurston on the coverage for Morehouse.
That's great coverage by Joshua Thurston. He turned his body to the ball, and by doing that, he pushes the receiver out of bounds with his shoulder. As long as the DB is looking back for the ball, the referees typically will not throw the flag. That's very good coverage by Joshua Thurston.
Smart defensive play.
Oh, very smart defensive play.
And when you have Morehouse, smart is the standard.
These guys are future judges and lawyers and astronauts.
And they had to take midterms this week, so this was a long week. Also dealing with the loss to their cross-campus rival, Clark Atlanta. Second down and 10. Burkett with some time. Finds a receiver in Monquel Franklin, but well short of the first down. Only a 5-yard gain brings up a third down situation. Emmanuel Parks on the tackle.
James, Burkett is doing a good job of staying in the pocket and taking his drops, whether it be three steps or five steps, and throwing the ball on that third or fifth step. He's given his receivers a good opportunity to get to the football, and they're making some catches out there.
Trying to get his team a line straight, getting the call from the sideline. For Burkett, according to Coach Slater, this is his time to shine, and so far, he's been shining bright.
He's done a very good job in his reserve role. Well, Nard is out.
Caleb Williams eludes one, two tacklers, has a lot of green space, 20. 10, touchdown, Caleb Williams, Golden Tigers, 48 yards on the pitch and catch.
Good job by Caleb Williams trying to keep the play alive and not going down after first contact. Burkett gets the ball out there. You've got a big offensive lineman out there making blocks as well. He had protection all the way down the field with another wide receiver. It's a very good play.
And the official says, no, it's not a touchdown. He stepped out at about the 14-yard line, a 35-yard gain. Everyone's cheering it's a touchdown. Even one of the referees threw his arms up. But the side judge says, no, he stepped out of bounds. Low, out of the fair pass from Burkett. And he pays the price, but able to break through. Do they call it a score?
Give it to him.
Yes! Touchdown, Golden Tigers. Hodrick Lowe with the big play. 13 yards, and yet there is a flag.
It's a flag for an unsportsmanlike, I think, James, because he took his helmet off. Lowe did a good job just now by sticking his foot in the ground instead of being pushed out of bounds by the defense, and that allowed him to get one more plunge for the pylon.
You were correct. Unsportsmanlike, most likely excessive
celebration. But the way Morehouse has struggled to put points on the board, those guys were happy just now to score. I understand.
The play is a touchdown. Unsportsmanlike conduct, number 9 on the offense. Penalty will be 15 yards, assessed on the kick. One on time down.
Hodrick Lowe, and you can see he is celebrating a little bit. The freshman from Atlanta, Grady High School, getting an opportunity to shine. Wiley with the kick. And it is successful. 3:20 left to play, 25-3, and the drive, 70 yards.
This is a good, hard, tough run by Hodrick Lowe after the catch. Turn the ball up the field, take some contact, stick that foot in the ground, and continue to lunge to get to that pylon. That's a lot of effort by Lowe just now to get into the zone.
And Burkett, 4 for 6 on the drive for 70 yards, capped off by Lowe's second effort for the score.
Tuskegee's running game hasn't been working as it usually does, so they've decided to go to the air. Coach Slater's not afraid to throw the ball. He's got comparable players back there at the quarterback position that can get that ball in the air, and his receivers are catching the passes right now.
Coach Slater always stays even keel, not too high, not too low. And for Hodrick Lowe, he's rather high right now, yeah, knowing that he's got a couple of touchdowns under his belt.
Very excited, putting forth a lot of effort in today's ball game so far in the first half. And Lowe's done a good job of smelling the end zone and finding a way to get into it.
Wiley has been a busy man, and for TJ Williams and Joshua Thurston back deep for Morehouse, they need a big play as they trail 25-3 with 3:20 left to play in the first half.
Yeah, being down by 23 in the first half would be dangerous, so Morehouse needs to try to find a way to put some points on the board before the half.
Williams from his own 15, eludes one defender. Another has a hole, but tripped up at about the 44-yard line. Joseph Ross on the tackle. And are you a fan of the SIAC? Prove it by liking the SIAC on Facebook and following us on Instagram and Twitter. Stay connected and gain an inside look with behind-the-scenes access to your favorite student-athletes, programs, sports, and championships. Get all of your SIAC updates at thesiac.com.
Social media is taking over, James. Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. That's how people talk these days.
But they didn't have to use Twitter or anything to get this beautiful crowd.
I agree.
78 years and counting here in Columbus. Tarver, and he's brought down. Another sack by Aaron Bennett. And he's leading the way for the Bennett brothers.
Oh, the Bennett brothers better step their game up, because Aaron came to play today.
That was their 15th sack of the season as a team. Second best in the SIAC. And Mr. Tarver, Jordan Tarver, trying to regroup now, looking at 2nd and 15. Getting more pressure. Almost intercepted.
He might have it, James.
Depends on if they call it a catch.
He might have it. That was a beautiful play by Chin.
And no, they will say it's incomplete. Ooh. El Malik Chin.
Listen, he's covering down on number 2, displaced because it's 5 wide, and his job is to get to the flats and get underneath number 1. He stretched out and made a beautiful play.
Tip of the ball, hit the turf, ground. And you saw it spin.
Oh, gosh, that was a beautiful play. I talked earlier about Morehouse spreading them out, making the linebackers cover. Those guys don't have a problem doing so.
Trying to throw, interception.
Aggressive play.
Number 6, Travis Lee, we have called his name a lot this afternoon. Already scored on a block punt return, and now an interception. Defense playing big for the Golden Tigers.
A very aggressive play by the cornerback, Travis Lee. Sometimes as a DB, when you feel that you know what the route is, you run the route for the wide receiver, and that's what Travis Lee just did just now. He knew it was about a 10 to 12 yard out, and as the receiver turned to go out, he turned inside the receiver and got the interception. That's a great play with very good coverage.
And Travis Lee says he wants more. You see, 2 takeaways, 13 points off of the turnovers, and it could increase with 2:28 left to play here in the first half. But Tuskegee will call a timeout, trying to get their offense reset.
Tuskegee.
Ryan, this pick was textbook if you want to send something to a young player.
This is how you coach it right here. Three-step drop. You know the ball's coming out on that third step, and the corner turned right inside of the wide receiver. Very good play by Travis Lee. That's how you draw it up. A DB coach will use that right there as film to teach players how to make a play on a ball like that.
Now, if you're Jordan Tarver, how do you learn from making that mistake?
Well, you got to make sure that you get separation from the defensive back. You cannot allow the DB to read your route for you. So if he's inside of you like that and it's time for you to break, you've got to turn your body to make sure that he doesn't get inside of you to get to that ball.
Be sure you stay with us halftime for the Toyota Battle of the Bands featuring the Tuskegee Marching Crimson Piper Band and the Morehouse House of Funk Marching Band. Highly entertaining, world-class performances. Don't miss Toyota Battle of the Bands at halftime. I like the nickname Crimson Piper Band, but so far the best is House of Funk. I just want my bass. Briquette looking to add some scores. Almost a reception, but incomplete. Good defensive play by Morehouse.
Joshua Thurston
right there to make the play.
The DBs are really playing very good, solid coverage out there for the defense today. Big Darius Moore, when your helmet comes off, you've got to take a break. Go over there, get some adjustments to get that thing to steer in your head.
You see Rashad Briquette's number, 7 of 13, 138 yards, one score. Not bad, not necessarily overly impressive, but he is managing the team well.
What really makes it not bad, James, is the guy hadn't turned the ball over so far. That's what really makes it not bad.
Second down and 10. Briquette. And the dropsies come in. Larry Cobb going to him for a second time. And this time he touches the ball, but not able to hold on to it.
Would have easily been a catch for Larry Cobb just now. But prior to the ball being secured for the catch, he turns up to see what he could do after the catch, which ultimately made him not catch the ball, if that makes any sense.
It does.
Okay.
In some circles.
Okay.
All right. Coach Slater is not, well, we don't know. Is he happy? Is he sad? He's always right there in the media.
He's probably comfortable with a 23-point lead with almost 2 minutes left in the first half, but a coach will never let his team know that.
Briquette. And he is brought down, may have gotten back to the line of scrimmage, but good defensive play, a coverage sack, if they call it a sack. Brian Thomas leading the way for Morehouse on that play.
I think it's a slight loss, so it should be a coverage sack for the secondary of Morehouse. They did a good job of making sure that they were inside of their men when they turned around to look for the ball. Quarterback couldn't get it there because the pocket closed thanks to the pressure.
For only the second time this afternoon, a three and out for the Morehouse defense. Derek James, the punt. Williams back deep for Morehouse. He will try to return it, jumps up to make the reception and pays the price. Good open field tackle by Ahmad Muhammad, the young man from Birmingham, Alabama.
Jacoby Browder's got a lot of heart right there. Did a good job of not calling the fair catch, even though he saw the guys coming down into his personal space. But he secured the catch. Not a loss.
Minute 32 left to play in the first half. Tuskegee with a 26-3 lead at the 78th annual Tuskegee Morehouse Classic. Since 1935, they've played in this crown jewel city along the Chattahoochee River. And now for Morehouse, they're scrambling so they won't drown in the sea of points by the Golden Tigers. Incomplete, intended for Sean Moore, and he pays the price, and the young man is down.
El Malik Chin got his drop as a linebacker, and when he saw the ball be released by the quarterback, he came up and took a shot on Sean Moore that still has him on the ground right now. We talked about these Tuskegee linebackers. They're very, very aggressive when it comes to making contact with the opposition.
And we hope Sean Moore is okay. And you see the Crimson Piper Band from Tuskegee. Coming up at halftime, you will listen and see the Tuskegee Marching Crimson Pipers and, of course, the House of Funk Marching Band. And Moore is being helped off. You see he has a brace right there on the left leg. Hopefully he'll be okay, but he definitely paid a price on the last play.
He paid a price. Emily Chin, one of the better tacklers in the SIAC at the linebacker spot. Morehouse still running 4 or 5 wides, trying to spread the Tuskegee defense out.
Second and 10. Tarver. And once again, the middle of the field, El Malik Chin is making everyone pay. 2-yard gain on the play. Lance McGuffey able to make the reception, but he paid a price also.
El Malik Chin, Quavon Taylor, Marquise Mason, all three tackling machines. No one does it better than them. They're not going to shy away from contact. They always maintain good low pad level, and once they make contact, they typically bring down the player that they're hitting.
Third down and 8, 1:19 left to play. If you're the defense for the Golden Tigers, what do you want to try to do?
Well, defensively for the Golden Tigers, you want to make sure that you do not give up the big play. I'm not a guy that really believes in the prevent defenses in situations like this where it's late in the second quarter or late in the fourth quarter. I believe you still have the same mind frame that you've had that makes your team up 23 points going into the halftime. So just make sure they're in the right position, get good sound, deep drops, and keep the ball in front of them when it comes to being linebackers and guys in the secondary.
Rich Freeman and his staff, and they go into the locker room definitely trying to regroup offensively. Defensively, they played well enough to win. Special teams has really hurt Morehouse so far. Carver looking for McGuffey over his head, incomplete.
He's had a hard time when it comes to both quarterbacks for Morehouse. They had a hard time when it comes to rolling out to the right side and completing passes.
And Tarver will go to the headsets to listen to his offensive coaches as we approach the end of the first half. Timoteo Ogoro, who has already faked one punt this afternoon, he is the fastest person on Morehouse's team. He is the punter. Does not fake, kicks a boomer. Gardner will take it all the way back at his own 30. Spins out of one defender, spins out of another, and karate kicks one of his own guys. 50-yard punt, 13-yard return. Eric Robinson almost had his head knocked off by the feet of Gardner. But there's a flag all the way back at about the 30-yard line. I've never seen somebody do one spin move and then another gymnastic-type move to hit your own man.
Block in the back on the return team, number 23. Our penalty from the spot of the foul, first and 10.
Set the return team up with the fake to the right, goes back left, gets the block, and then bounces it back out. But, yeah, he had a lot of effort just now. He was spinning around like a spinning top.
He may have gotten his orange belt on that spin move. Less than a minute. Burkett finds low on the outside, has some room to run to the 30, has a lot of room to the near side, 40, low, beyond midfield, low, still on his feet, to the 20, and he's finally brought down. Hendrick Lowe, the Atlanta native, playing big for the Golden Tigers from Tuskegee.
And did you say he's a freshman, James?
True freshman.
This young man is instant offense as we've got two Morehouse defenders down on the ground still. Hodrick Lowe just has a lot of effort. He's got great balance, very quick feet. He's instant offense. He's very electric to see with the ball in his hands.
65 yards on the throw and catch from Burkett.
Quick little bubble screen, and Lowe just does a good job of reading the blocks that are set up for him and not going down with contact. Arm tackles are not going to get him. You've got to put your shoulders on him and get your head across the bow to tackle him. And look at the effort of all of his offensive linemen. Big number 72, Michael Thornton, all the way down the field 50 yards later, and he's a guy that's 300 plus pounds. I like Tuskegee's effort right now when it comes to every play that they're running.
Lance Bennett and Austin Clark, the two players down for Morehouse, and you're seeing Austin Clark right now. He's back on his feet. He's been making some big plays on the Morehouse defense. But right now, it is go time for Morehouse if they want to stop the Golden Tigers. Burkett, another pitch and catch to Caleb Williams. First down, and he's may have said a little bit to the defender for Morehouse. 12-yard gain for Tuskegee. Austin Bennett on the tackle for the Maroon Tigers. First and goal for Tuskegee.
The Tuskegee offensive lineman did a good job of chopping down the defensive line, making a good passing lane for the quarterback to throw the ball in the crossing route.
For Tuskegee, this has been an odyssey. They have been on the road every game so far this season, at Alabama A&M, at Albany State. They played Winston-Salem at a neutral site away from Tuskegee, at Lane College, at Fort Valley, and here in Columbus, Georgia. They don't make it home, I think, for one more week.
But when they get home, they'll be there for the remainder of the year, if I'm not mistaken, as they should, being on the road that long.
But coach says they didn't talk about it. They just take it one game at a time.
You got to play football. Doesn't matter if you're home or you're away, you got to play football.
20 seconds left to play in the first half, 26-3. Six plays over 20 yards, 13 points off of turnovers, and if they can get a score here, that can increase to 19, possibly 20 points off of turnovers. Lee along with Thornton in the backfield. Pitch out, low, easy, walk in, touchdown, Hodrick Lowe. 4-yard touchdown run. And for the first half, it's been a rout by Tuskegee.
Simple toss play where Hodrick Lowe read the block of his fullback as he cut down a defender, turned it right outside of him, and took it into the end zone for pay dirt.
Wiley, with this point after attempt, if successful, can make it a 30-point lead. And he has success. 15 seconds left to play in the 78th installment of the Tuskegee-Morehouse Classic. And Hodrick Lowe, so far, has been the first half hero.
Quick toss, getting the ball in Hodrick's hands. His fullback mowed down the defender right in front of him, and the hole was really, really wide for him to run through. Tuskegee's done a good job of opening holes all day long.
Third touchdown, two rushing, one receiving. And Coach Slater said, he's fast. We got one of the fastest teams since I've been here. And I said, okay, all coaches say teams are fast, but Lowe definitely has breakaway speed.
He's literally a very fast player.
Some people will say, how did Morehouse not get Hodrick Lowe, who went to Grady High School, not that far away from Morehouse College? But you also have to remember that Tuskegee, prestigious university, most likely out-recruited. And he does not stand very big, standing only 5'9", 170. but a fast 170.
Oh, that hurts.
And that's not what you want to do if you're TJ Williams. That is definitely one you want to get back.
Oh, my gosh.
When it rains, it pours in Columbus.
Just a simple slip. Trying to make sure he does a good job of catching the football, gets his body underneath it, and he just slips, James.
And I know TJ will definitely want that play back. He's beating himself up. Not a happy camper right now. And Rich Freeman looking to go back to the drawing board at halftime. Right now, you got to be careful. You don't want to kneel it in the end zone. Smart play by Tarver, able to get some positive yards as we wind down the first half. And what we have seen, Ryan, is a display of a total team effort by Willie Slater and his Tuskegee Golden Tigers.
This team has won a few championships over the past few years, including last year's championship over Fort Valley. And they do a good job of establishing the line of scrimmage defensively and offensively. They're securing the football when it comes to not dropping it. And they're just playing better football than Morehouse is right now.
And if you're Morehouse right now going in the half, you've got to find a way to stop making bad mistakes that's causing Tuskegee to have short fields.
Bad mistakes, fumbles, a few penalties, and you're exactly right. When you give Tuskegee the short field, it's easy for them to score because their offense is so potent.
Let's go down to Doug Stewart, who is with the Morehouse head coach.
Coach Freeman, obviously penalties and turnovers killed you in the first half. What do you say to your team at halftime?
Well, I just got to let them know that, hey, they're already tough enough. They're a tough football team, plenty of tradition and history. We got to stop helping them to win this football game. They don't need any help. So we got to stop helping them and start being the more responsible football team.
Good luck to you at halftime, Coach. Back up to you guys.
Thanks a lot, Doug. When we come back, the House of Funk will take the field. Halftime here at the 78th annual Tuskegee Morehouse Classic right here on Bounce.
Hi, Mrs. Landers. Your eyeglasses.
Welcome to the Toyota Battle of the Bands Halftime Show, brought to you by Toyota. Introducing the all-new 2014 Next Generation Corolla. Toyota, let's go places.
Welcome back to Columbus, Georgia, and let's listen to the Morehouse House of Funk marching band.
Thank you.
the House of Funk serenades the fans. We'll be back with more of the Toyota Battle of the Bands HBCU football on Bounce. Welcome back to HBCU football on Bounce. Let's continue with more of the Toyota Battle of the Bands. Of the Toyota Battle of the Bands when we come back on HBCU Football on Bounce. Listen,
baby. Detroit is all about the sound and the drive. Dedication to our passion is what defines us.
Welcome back to halftime of the Morehouse Tuskegee Classic. 33-3 is your score. Let's enjoy the final song from from the Crimson Pipers from Tuskegee.
Toyota Battle of the Bands Halftime Show was brought to you by Toyota. Let's go places.
Back at A.J. McClung Stadium in the city of Columbus, Georgia, 78th annual Morehouse Tuskegee Classic. And James Verrett along with Ryan Stewart. And Ryan, it has been all Tuskegee for the first half.
When it comes to on the ground, running the ball, in the air, passing the ball, Tuskegee's really out-physicaled Morehouse all the way around in today's football game.
It started early with a block punt, and it was off to the races after that.
Special teams do an outstanding job. Had a guy come right outside of the end and just get the block punt. And Lowe, one of his first touchdowns, following his blocker, fullback did an outstanding job of laying the block down, getting to the end zone. And right here, the fullback himself finding his way to the end zone. Little quick little screen pass right out here, a little flare pass, and Lowe just having the intestinal fortitude not to get stopped. And again, following his blockers with gaping holes, getting into the end zone.
And you see the numbers from the first half. Outstanding job by Tuskegee, 214 passing yards, not known as a large passing team with their starting quarterback out. And you see Morehouse unable to get a lot started on offense.
322 total yards offensively for Tuskegee, only 137 for Morehouse. They've got to do a better job of getting physical at the point of attack if they want to win this ball game.
Let's throw it down to the kick, Mr. Wiley. And T.J. Williams on the return at his own three, and he is met by a wall of gold and crimson. Moments ago, Doug Stewart caught up with head coach for Tuskegee, Willie Slater.
Coach Slater, obviously you guys got this game in a great position right now, very comfortable lead. What do you preach at halftime? Do you preach finish the drill, consistency? What do you tell your team?
I really haven't told them anything. We talked about it before the game started. We just want to play one quarter at a time, one play at a time, and just be consistent. So that's what I'm looking for, consistency. And then if we're slacking off, and then I'll get them when they come to the sideline.
Good luck in the second half. Back to the booth.
Thanks a lot, Doug. And right now we got a player for Morehouse who is a little bit. Don Cox is the player who is looks like either he hurt himself or he is safe to say he's trying to get to the sideline.
It looks like he might be trying to catch his breath out there. Now he's taking a knee. And they're bringing a replacement on the field for him.
Shoulder in the chest, and that'll knock the wind and a little bit more out of him.
Yeah, he just needed a couple of minutes to get himself together.
That may be the first time I've seen a player not go down, but definitely go out.
He's a little more upbeat now, so maybe he'll be back in the ballgame shortly.
Rich Freeman, his squad trying to get only their second victory against Tuskegee since he has been head coach at Morehouse. Hamilton with a hold, able to gain about 8, possibly 9 yards, close to a first down for the Maroon Tigers. Michael Robinson on the tackle for Tuskegee.
That's something that Morehouse is going to have to do a better job of, opening up holes for Hamilton to run through.
First down, they will give him 10 yards on that carry. First and 10. Tarver still in at quarterback. They started with Monquavius Johnson, but Jordan Tarver in. Once again, Hamilton barreling his way toward another first down. Tyron Thurman on the tackle.
Morehouse trying to just establish the run early. Maybe get Tuskegee coming downhill to play a little bit more aggressive when it comes to stopping the run, and then they'll try to go over top with a few passes.
Strong rushing attack by Morehouse once again, giving the Hamilton. This time, though, Tuskegee able to stop and Trier Bennett on the tackle.
We've seen the same play 3 times in a row. Once to the left, then to the right, and back to the left.
Second down. Call it 8. Tarver with plenty of time throws, and no one is home to catch that pass.
Very good job for Morehouse's offensive line when it comes to protecting Tarver in the pocket just now. But unfortunately, Tuskegee's secondary did a good job of covering the wide receivers, and Tarver couldn't find anyone down the field to throw the ball to.
Rich Freeman trying to get the right plays in to keep his young redshirt freshman quarterback calm, cool, and collected. Third down and 8. Will they call it a catch? Yes, they will call it a catch. Devon Mann, the leading receiver for Morehouse, with the catch, 15 yards on the reception into Tuskegee territory.
Very good job right there by keeping his feet in bounds, toe tapping right there. Only needs one in college, but he got 2 down, and it was a very good pocket for Tarver to throw the ball out of just now.
Handoff, nowhere fast. Douglas Weish getting one of his first carries of the year.
Mixing it up right now, giving Hamilton a little bit of a blow. He's done a very good job of toting the rock all day long.
Weish, young man from Hampton, Virginia, redshirt freshman.
Again, we've talked about it. Coach Freeman's depending on a lot of younger players to help his ball club so far this season.
Second down, 8. Tarver. Intended for man, but well over his head for an incompletion.
Morehouse likes running a lot of those deep outs, and the quarterback hadn't done a good job of completing those passes so far in today's ball game. Third down,
8. Ninth play of the drive, trailing 33-3. The men of Morehouse looking to bounce back and try to have an impressive second half.
So far, they've done a good job of establishing their drive, keeping the ball moving. They've got a couple of first downs so far coming out of the halftime.
Tarver getting some pressure. Pass intended for Don Cox, but Cox could not come down with the reception.
Tarver did his job, James. Read the pocket well, got away from a little bit of pressure, and threw the ball to Cox. Hit Cox right in the hands, and as he was trying to grab it and pull it in, he threw the ball to the ground.
Fourth down and 8. They are in Tuskegee territory, trailing by 30 points. No time to punt now. It's go time for the Maroon Tigers.
The O-line's done such a good job protecting Tarver so far in the second half. Maybe he drops back and keeps the ball and tries to get as many yards as possible.
Tarver getting a lot of pressure, has some room to run, decides to run, breaks the line of scrimmage, gets the first, smartly dives down, first and 10 inside the 30, 16-yard gain for Jordan Tarver.
Well, maybe it wasn't a drawn-up quarterback draw like I suggested prior to the play, but still the same effect. Drop back, allowed the defense to spread out a little bit, and as the pocket collapsed on him, he bounced outside, saw a running lane, and took it.
First and 10, ball on the 29-yard line. Spin move, nowhere fast for Shelton Hamilton.
For Hamilton to be dealing with an ACL that he had work on last season, he does a good job of spinning and keeping his pad level low and not going down at first contact.
Just starting the third quarter. Morehouse unable to get a touchdown in the first half. They're on their second quarterback of the afternoon. Marquavius Johnson with the starter. Now we see Jordan Tarver. Hamilton trying to find a hole, patiently finds his way forward to about the 27-yard line, 3-yard gain by Hamilton.
Little off-tackle play with the lead blocker. Somewhat of a pistol formation for Morehouse. Quarterback displaced from behind the center, but not quite in a shotgun stance.
13th play of the drive, 7 rushes, 5 passes. This is the way you want to start a football game, but for Morehouse, they're starting the second half this way. Tarver with plenty of time. He gets hit from behind, able to get the pass off to Lance McGuffey, but still short of the first down, brings up another fourth down situation. Quavon Taylor for Tuskegee on the tackle, 5-yard gain.
Quavon Taylor did a good job of dropping deep enough to kind of control that secondary area behind the linebackers, and when the ball was released by Tarver just now, came up and made the tackle.
And for the second time this drive, Morehouse will go for it on fourth down.
That's the way, guys! Over there!
Trying to get the formation correct. Tarver with plenty of time. Finds a receiver and Cox. Touchdown, Morehouse! Don Cox, 22-yard reception, and Morehouse sends a message early.
Sends a message early, established a very good drive, throwing the ball and running the ball. Quarterback played smart football on the entire drive, especially getting everyone lined up properly just now for the touchdown play. Stays in the pocket, reads his receivers, sees Cox dragging across the field, gets it to him in a spot where he can run with the ball after the catch and gets the touchdown. Good job by Tarver just now when it comes to making sure everybody was in the right spot to have a successful play.
And Solis with the point after attempt, which is good. 10:07 left to play in the third quarter, and Jordan Tarver, Don Cox, winning combination as they still trail 33-10 right here on Bounce.
When you take your laptop or iPad to a public...
One of the good things about the Morehouse Tuskegee Football Classic is the tailgating and some of the fans right there next to the Bounce TV Our Way banner. And you know, some things that go good with barbecue is gossip, and the celebrities, fresh news, hot gossip. Bounce TV is breaking down what's up with an all-new original series. Don't miss the premiere of Breakdown Monday night, 10:30 Eastern, 9:30 Central, only on Bounce. Seems though every time that you go to a barbecue, you always hear some chitter chatter.
People talking barbecues, James. That's what it's all about.
And some people who are Morehouse fans will be talking about Jordan Tarver, 7 of 16, 65 yards, his first career touchdown as a Maroon Tiger.
Very good drive, and you're talking about being the third man on the totem pole when it comes to playing the quarterback position. He did a good job of orchestrating a perfect drive to get his offense on the board in the second half.
And now it'll be Hector Solis' job to kick away from the dangerous return men in Hodrick Lowe, who already has three touchdowns on offense for the Golden Tigers, and Tyree Brooks. They kick away from Lowe over to Tyree Brooks, who takes it inside his own 20 and is brought down at about the 26-yard line. 10-yard return off of the kick, Kamar Smith on the tackle. And now it's time for the SIAC trivia question. Who was the first SIAC player selected in the first round of the NFL draft? Make sure you go to SIAC fan page on Facebook or Twitter and post your answer using the hashtag SIAC trivia.
I know, James. Can I answer? I know.
No, but I will give the fans a hint. He was a very, very dangerous man. This time, Lowe is quickly wrapped up by Richard Sanders for a loss.
Sanders did a good job of getting one of those big old paws on Lowe just now, and Lowe tried to spin out of it, but he maintained his grip and brought him down to the ground for a tackle for a loss.
See the numbers on Kyle Pogue, who has come in a reserve from the middle linebacker spot. 22 tackles, one for a loss. Right now, when you've seen so much offense from the Golden Tigers, all of your defensive players have to be ready to go just to spell the guys who are starting.
The defense has been on the field a very long time, and the offense is putting up good yardage offensively in the air and on the ground. So, yeah, the first and the second team defense need to be ready to play some football.
Nice throw and catch. Thurston trying to bring down Larry Cobb.
Look at the effort by Cobb.
Cobb with a 10-yard reception. Thurston was right there trying to just bring him down. Got to remember that Thurston is only 5'7", 165.
Right. He had a hard time getting him down, and Cobb stayed on his feet the entire play.
Third down and 6.
But you're right, James, in a ball game like today when the score is as lopsided as it is, Coach Freeman will get the opportunity to see what a lot of other guys that typically wouldn't be able to play in a close ball game can do.
Fullback with a big move, Thornton. Thornton trying to outrun defenders, but finally brought down deep in the Morehouse territory. First down and 10 for the Golden Tigers. Lance Bennett with a touchdown-saving tackle after the 41-yard gain.
Michael Thornton hits the hole on a fullback dive. The hole opens up like so wide, and he just punches the ball through, runs as hard as he can. Very significant yardage on the carry.
He runs a little wild.
Yeah.
You never see fullbacks so loose the way he runs.
They're not loose to getting used. They're not used to getting loose down in the open field like he's been doing so far today.
Pitch out to Lowe. like coming out of a slingshot, he's able to get positive yards close to a first down for the Golden Tigers. Lance Bennett on the tackle for Morehouse. Little talking. Obviously, Morehouse not happy.
Michael Thornton, the fullback, makes another good block, opening up a hole for Lowe to go through, and that's what the talking was about. You got a defender that's saying, hey, man, stay off my knees, and you've got Thornton saying, keep me off of your knees.
9-yard gain brings up a second and short.
We talked about Coach Slater and how aggressive he coaches his team to play. They go after it on every single play.
8 plays of 20 yards or more today for the Golden Tigers from Tuskegee, Alabama. Lowe looking for a hole, has one, 10, 5. Once again, Lowe is riding high into the end zone.
Very nice misdirection play.
18 yards on the touchdown run. The freshman from Atlanta's Grady High School playing big in the Tuskegee-Morehouse Classic.
Tuskegee's ran the lead play so many times today. When the fullback went out to the left, the defense kind of followed his flow to the left or their right, and Lowe bounces the ball back to the opposite side on a misdirection play. Very well called play by the Tuskegee Golden Tigers.
Wiley, point after attempt is up, and success for the kicker. 7:18 left to play in the third quarter, and there was a late flag, but we'll find out when we come back. But Hodrick Lowe having a career afternoon right here on Bounce. HBCU football on Bounce. 78th annual Tuskegee-Morehouse Classic. And the man who is staying ahead of the Chattahoochee River Current is Hodrick Lowe. His numbers are incredible. You see, for the first 5 games, 41 touches, 269 yards, 3 TDs. Today, 11 carries, 178 yards, and a whopping 4 touchdowns.
I'm impressed. I'm impressed with the young man's effort. I'm impressed with his vision when it comes to finding the open hole. I'm impressed with how he allows his blockers to get in front of him to open holes and read their blocks. He's been a total all-around back in today's ballgame.
Not bad for the true freshman who enrolled in school of the spring semester, had a whole semester to get acclimated to college life, participated in spring football, had according to Coach Slater, he has earned the job, and none of the other backs, which includes some D1 transfers, have been able to take the job away from him.
How excited must Coach Slater be when you've got a freshman that's having such success at an early age?
And now Trevor Wiley showing that he's getting wily like a cat, kicking it out of the end zone. Let's go back to the SIAC trivia. Who was the first SIAC player selected in the first round of the NFL draft? The answer, Henry Killer Lawrence, a former All-American offensive tackle, was the 19th overall pick in 1974, drafted by the Oakland Raiders, coached by John Madden. Lawrence played 13 seasons and was a 3-time Super Bowl champion. Now, I've never heard of an offensive tackle who could come with a name, Killer.
He had a lot of pancakes, James. He had a lot of pancakes.
No. A lot of kills. He had a lot of kills. So obviously with the Raiders or with Florida A&M, they didn't say pancakes.
They called it kills.
Lake McGuffey. And looks like Lake is draining with pain.
He's trying to stand, but he's going to have to go to the sideline. Tuskegee, whether you catch the ball or not, they're laying their shoulders on you with heavy contact.
Got to give Morehouse players credit. They're not going to the ground.
No.
They're in pain, but they're not going to the ground. Hamilton, been the only constant for Morehouse's offense. No gain, brings up third down.
Here's a situation where Coach Slater, because of the score and how lopsided it is, being up by 30 points in the middle of the third quarter, he'll be able to go into his bench now to allow a few players that typically don't see time to get a little action to them.
Morehouse looking to come back from being down 30. Throw and catch. Reception made by McGuffey, Lance McGuffey, and now he is cramping up. Now, that's not what you want to see from one of your reserve wide receivers, Michael Robinson, on the tackle for Tuskegee. How do you cramp up when, but granted, he hasn't played much and he has been playing some significant time today.
That's exactly what it is. His body really isn't used to the time that he's received in today's ball game because he hadn't played that much. He's been a reserve player. So now his body probably needs a little bit of salt, needs to get a little bit more fluids inside of him. He's not used to the workload that he's endured today.
Pickles.
Pickles help.
Let's take a look at other SIAC scores of teams that are playing today. Central State with a upset in the making, taking on Miles College 25-14. Benedict trails Stillman 21-10. Lane College ahead of Albany. Very interesting scores there. Make sure you log on to SIAC.com to get all your latest on the SIAC. Douglas Weish on the carry, 7 yards. El Malik Chen on the tackle for Tuskegee.
Weish, after the good run, now has to go to the sideline because his shoe came off.
And he's a redshirt freshman. He'll learn how to keep those shoes tied up tight.
And I need some Velcro.
Going to give to Hamilton, and Hamilton gets beyond midfield into Tuskegee territory before he's brought down. Led the way, Quavon Taylor, 2 yard gain for the Maroon Tigers.
Tarver and Hamilton's been doing a good job of running a read type of action with this play. Tarver hadn't kept the ball at all so far while running this play. Look for him to pull that ball out and scamper on the sideline sometime here in the third quarter.
Third and short. Give to TJ Williams, Quavon Taylor and company right there to say no way. El Malik Chen also in on the tackle. Negative 2 yards. And now that linebacking core really starting to flex their muscles.
Yeah, that's a very good linebacking core. They do a good job of coverage that we've seen today while Morehouse tried to spread them out with 3, 4, and 5 wide receivers. They stayed on the field, just got a little bit of depth, got a little bit of whip, and still made plays in the passing game. And when it comes to the run, they're downhill stoppers, man. They do a very good job of controlling that line of scrimmage.
Agoro back to punt. Gardner back deep for Tuskegee. Now, this is a high punt, but short. Takes a Morehouse bounce and is downed inside the 40 at about the 38. 4:26 left to play in the third quarter on the 13-yard Agoro punt. 40-10 is your score in favor of the Golden Tigers. Welcome back to HBCU football on Bounce. 40-10, the Golden Tigers of Tuskegee with the lead. Time now for our Chrysler 300 Motown. Great drive of the half, and it came 5 plays, 72 yards, capped off by this 18-yard speedy run by Hodrick Lowe, his 4th touchdown of the afternoon. That is our Chrysler 300 Motown edition. Great drive of the half.
Surprised Hodrick Lowe isn't cramping up out there as much running as he's done up and down this field.
Little thing called being in shape. And Coach Lader did give his guys credit, saying that they did a phenomenal job during the offseason. The majority of the team stayed in Tuskegee for the summer working out, and he said he did not have to worry about conditioning, and it shows this afternoon. Brooks trying to find a hole and is pushed out of bounds, but not before he gains some positive yards.
Tyree Brooks ended up bouncing the ball outside because things were clogged up inside, and the defensive line of Morehouse did a good job of running down the line of scrimmage with their shoulder pad square to the line, not allowing that daylight to open up for the running back.
They'll spot the ball at about the 41-yard line. Make it 2nd and 6. Keeper Burkett trying to find a hole. Has some room to run past midfield. Good block by his running back, and Thurston's right there to bring him down, but not before a big first down, and he's saying the champ is here.
Really excited about how Tyree Brooks just now stayed with the play even though he didn't get the ball and came back to make the block. Burkett, see Brooks run past him just now and come back to make that block? That's not a block in the bag. They couldn't throw a flag on that, James.
Replay, second down.
You do want your head to go in the front of the body of the person you're blocking, because if your head is not across the bow and behind the player, from time to time, referees will throw that flag, which is what happened just now. Great effort play, though.
And the yards will take them back with the penalty to their own 45. So instead of first down deep into Morehouse territory, it's second and three. And looks like they had movement.
Tuskegee's run the ball downhill so hard today, Morehouse is tired of it. They're trying to get a jump on the snap so they can penetrate that line before those backers or those running backs start coming downhill.
Marcus Woods, our referee this afternoon.
Snapping fraction. Number 78, 5 penalty. Still second down.
One of the reserve offensive linemen for Tuskegee.
Now's the time where you can dig into that bench and let some depth, guys that typically don't play, get a few snaps. Let them feel the game of football.
Option. Burkett gets it out to Brooks. Close to another first down. Richard Sanders, young man from Atlanta, 6-yard gain for the Golden Tigers.
Tyree Brooks did a very good job of keeping the pitch option relationship wide open with Rashard Burkett just now. Never knowing if the quarterback's going to pitch that ball, but you've got to make sure that you're behind him just in case he does, so they've got a positive gain on the play.
Third and short.
Regular eye formation, tight end, two wide receivers, coming downhill, James.
Give to Joshua Lowe, breaks the line of scrimmage and pushes his way forward enough for a first down, 3-yard gain for Joshua Lowe, the young man from Salagua, Alabama.
Another fullback dive. Coach Slater is very generous with his fullbacks. He lets them get touches of the football.
Right at midfield. Burkett finds Franklin. Franklin with positive yards. Thurston on the tackle for Morehouse.
Time and pattern for Burkett and Franklin. Run field 10 to 12 yards, hard as you can, pushing the DBs off. And when you turn around, the quarterback's job is to have that ball on the way to a spot. It's a wonderful play.
8-yard gain brings up second and short. Call it three. To Brooks. Brooks pushing his way forward. First down and more, down to about the 30. An 11-yard gain, and now you're starting to see how much depth they have at running back with Tyree Brooks.
Tuskegee's quite frankly just worn down the interior of the defense of Morehouse. Offensive linemen doing a good job of pushing the defensive line and the linebackers around and the backs not going down with first contact, continuing to keep their legs moving and even spinning if need be.
Keeping it on the ground, Brooks breaks the line of scrimmage, has some more room to run, and trying to get to the 20-yard line, but a host of white shirts right there to stop him a couple of yards away. They'll call it 11 yards on the gain, another first down for the Golden Tigers.
Watch fullback Joshua Crow here if we can get a replay. Number 20. They snap the ball. He comes downfield and does a good job of finding someone to lay out. Cut block, which allows his running back to get about another 3 or 4 yards.
Burkett looking to throw. Catch made. Tackle. Bentavious Miller, his first reception of the afternoon, the junior from Dueling, Georgia. Joshua Thurston right there on the tackle. 15-yard pass play to end the third quarter. One more quarter to go. 78 years, bands in full effect, but it's been all Tuskegee football as they have a 30-point lead going into the fourth quarter. Listen. 40 to 10 is your score. The Golden Tigers from Tuskegee over the Maroon Tigers of Morehouse. Let's have more on the trophy. Let's go down to Doug Stewart.
Yeah, it's the 78th consecutive Tuskegee-Morehouse Classic, and they're playing for this trophy right here. It's not the oldest rivalry, but it's the oldest active rivalry in the sport. They first lined up against each other back in 1902. Back then, old Teddy Roosevelt was the president of these here United States of America. This is the 103rd time that they played. They've been playing here in Columbus at A.J. McClung Stadium since 1936. Tuskegee, as you would expect, with 29 SIAC championships, have dominated this series. Before Morehouse beat the Golden Tigers in 2011, they hadn't won since 2003, and it looks like they're going to rack up another one today. Back to you guys.
Thanks a lot, Doug. Seems as though they're running out of trophy space.
It's got a lot of them, geez. My goodness, they've got a lot of them.
So far in this drive, as we start the fourth quarter, 7 plays, 5 runs, 2 have been passes. Staying with the eye to start the fourth. Gives to Brooks, trying to find a hole, one man to beat, and he does. Touchdown, Golden Tigers, 6-yard touchdown run for the young man from Bartow, Florida.
It's simple power football, James. Full line of scrimmage with the tight end, full backfield with the fullback and a tailback. You run downhill, fullback makes his block, and you read off of him. Just now, the bounce outside was where the move was, and they got the touchdown.
Tyree Brooks, only his second touchdown of the season. Wiley. Kick is good with 14:53 left to play.
Very good play. Fullback went to the right. Tyree Brooks bounced it outside. Take it right outside of the tackles. Had contact about the 2-3 yard line, but kept his feet moving and got into the end zone. These guys run hard. They run downhill, they run hard.
Brooks transferred from Eastern Arizona Community College, and Coach Slater does a great job of scouring the United States, trying to find the best football players he can to play for his team.
He's got some talent, James.
So far this season, this is the most points scored by Tuskegee so far this year. Previous high was 42 points against Central State, and they've already eclipsed that with 14:53 left to play. They could put maybe 10 or 15 more up there.
Yeah, if they really wanted to, James, I'm sure they could. Everything they're doing in today's ball game is working. And it's no trick plays. It's just playing power football.
Washington. And he gets out to about the 26. When you think of Tuskegee, you think of championships. They have the most wins in all of black college football with 644. SIAC championships, 29. HBCU national titles, 8. And they have been a member of the SIAC since 1913.
Coach Slater's done the exact same thing as we talked to Coach Freeman on yesterday after Morehouse's walkthrough. He said they're going to line up and just try to out-physical you. They're not playing any trick football. They're not about that.
On the kicking team, number 35. 5 yards will be added to the end of the run. First and 10.
This is where Coach Freeman can test the heart of his players to make sure that they stay in the game mentally and physically and don't give up on them, even though the score has them down by 37 points.
Jordan Tarver still in at quarterback for Morehouse. Give to Hamilton, and he's able to gain possibly 2 yards, make it 3.
To the 35.
And now if you're Morehouse, how do you go back to the drawing board and break what 9 out of 10 times would be a 2-game losing streak?
James, this is one of the games where Coach Freeman and his staff might not even show them the film this week. You just want to forget this one, move on, and start working on the fundamentals of football again. Simple blocking and tackling the opponent.
And Tarver throws this one to no one, and a flag. Good defensive play by the Golden Tigers, able to put a lot of pressure.
Tarver tried to throw it away so he wouldn't be.
Ball will be placed in the spot of the lost it down. Third down.
Tarver tried not to take the sack by throwing it away, but because he was inside the tackle box, it's going to be a grounding call. You've got to get outside the tackle before throwing the ball away, and the ball has to go or make it at least to the line of scrimmage.
Aaron Bennett along with Brandon Dorsey there to apply pressure.
Listen to the communication of the linebacker corps, Marquise Mason, Tuskegee. Getting everybody lined up the right way.
Third and 23. Only sending 4. Tarver throwing long and overthrows everyone. If you're going to throw it long, that's how you want to do it.
If you're not going to put it where only your guy can get it, throw it where nobody can get it.
Once again, Ogoro into punt, Gardner back deep for Tuskegee.
Tuskegee should be getting the ball with good position, good field position after this punt. Ogoro's last punt wasn't too good, so let's see if he does a better job this game.
Little bit better punt. Gardner will return it at it from his own 45, and he is brought down inside Morehouse's 40-yard line down to about the 38. And it was Ogoro on the tackle. When we come back, 47-10 is your score. Golden Tigers trying to put this classic on ice.
It's time to change the way we clean. It's time to free ourselves from the smell and harshness of bleach.
Golden Tiger fans from across the globe will be happy to know their team has a 47-10 lead in the fourth. Sometimes when family loses touch, one good recipe can make everyone back to the table. Vanessa Williams, Vivica Fox, starring Soul Food, Monday night, 8 p.m. Eastern, 7 p.m. Central, only on Bounce. And they got a lot of good food out here. People will be tailgating well until the night. New quarterback for the Golden Lions, Golden Tigers, and knocked out of bounds. Kevin Lacy, the third string quarterback from Wetumpka, Alabama, Lance Bennett on the tackle, 30 yards on the keeper. But there is a flag right at midfield.
Coach Slater wanting to see what Lacey's going to bring to the table. Perfect opportunity to get him a few snaps. You never know when you have to depend on some of your backups later on in the season.
Offense, number 36, 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Replay first down.
Yep, you can see the hole right here. Got his hands inside where you want them, but when the defender tries to break away from you, you've got to let him go. I mean, offensive players can hold as long as their hands are inside while they're holding.
Kevin Lacey, a true freshman, stands 6'6", 175 pounds. And he keeps it again. This time he goes beyond midfield. The long legs of Lacey. 10 down to the 5. That's a tall drink of water who can run. Lance Bennett on a touchdown saving tackle.
6'6".
57 yards for the guy who stands way taller than me.
6'6", 175 yards, a real long stride. Fakes the handoff. Saw daylight and just ran to it.
And his braids are just flowing in the wind.
Good job by DeMario Dixon for Morehouse, not giving up on the play, making the tackle inside of the 5-yard line.
He is extremely tall, extremely skinny, and extremely fast. He's extreme.
He's extreme.
Lacey fumbles the football. Oh, well, when you got all those positives, negative maybe you got small hands.
Kind of pulled away from the center before the ball was in his hands. That'll happen.
Got baby hands.
Baby hands, excited, anxious to get the ball and make a play with it.
3-yard loss for Kevin Lacey. We've seen two out of the three quarterbacks for Tuskegee. Their first string quarterback, Justin Nard, is out with an injury. Got hurt last week against Fort Valley. Burkett has had a wonderful day, and Lacey is lighting it up, making the Tuskegee fans here happy. He's going to keep once again, and he is met by a wall of white shirts, and a helmet comes off, and now we see his lime green headgear. He has everything going.
Thanks to the helmet coming off, he'll have to take a play off.
What is that on his head? He looks like a highlighter. He looks like a tall, skinny highlight. 1-yard gain.
Charles Drinkard will get an opportunity.
Now we're on quarterback number 4.
Number 4.
He's going to give to his fullback, who is in for the score. Jerome Lewis from Decatur, Southwest DeKalb. Freshman. All the baby Golden Tigers getting in. 5-yard touchdown run. Now we've gone past the 50-cent piece in this game for Tuskegee.
Here's what's discouraging to see as a fan of the game, and I'm sure it's discouraging for Coach Freeman. You're down by 43 points and your team is disengaged. The Maroon Tigers, majority of them sitting on the bench, really not into the ball game right now.
10:57 left to play, and even the youngest of the Golden Tigers find their way into the end zone. 54-10 is your score right here on Bounce. Welcome back to HBCU football on Bounce. Football our way. 78th annual Tuskegee-Morehouse Classic. 54-10 is your score. The Golden Tigers. It's time now for the Gillette Fusion Pro Glide Precision play of the game. Flare pass to Hudrick Lowe, and Lowe on second effort with the touchdown. Our Gillette Fusion Pro Glide Precision play of the game.
A lot of effort from Lowe all day long. Just wouldn't give up. Continued to keep his legs moving. Showed great effort every single run or every single time he had the ball in his hands.
This young man has a very bright future. Only a true freshman had a career day today here in Columbus, Georgia at A.J. McClung Memorial Stadium. And for the Golden Tiger fans, they will not forget this one, 54-10, as Wiley will kick it off.
And there's right shy of 11 minutes left to play football.
T.J. Williams will take this at his own five. And he is brought down before he gets to the 20-yard line. DeMarquise Lumpkin, the running back and special teamers from Orrville, Alabama. Just for today, Tuskegee, they normally average about 23 points a game. Today, 54 points. They've had 9 plays of 20 yards or more. Low, 178 yards, 4 TDs. And the defense, we haven't talked a lot about the defense, 6 sacks and 3 takeaways.
Brand new secondary back there with last season pretty much losing their entire secondary. They did a good job of putting pressure on the opposing quarterback up front with the front 4 and 7, and the secondary did a great job of coverage.
And they give to Weish, and Weish breaks one tackle, breaks away to get some positive yards, 5-yard gain for Weish. Mason on the tackle.
You want to see Morehouse stay encouraged. You want to see them continue to play football. Try to take some positives away by doing something positive offensively here in this fourth quarter of a pretty tough ball game.
Tarver coming in to spell Monquavius Johnson, who is still nursing a bad ankle that he turned about 3 weeks ago. Give to Weish, and he's trying to work his way for some positive yards, but a wall of crimson and gold after the 1-yard gain by Weish. And Weish is like, why me? Well, you're there and they're hungry.
This is a ball game where both coaches, Coach Slater and Coach Freeman,
see the Bennett brothers out there, Aaron and Trier. They got one more, Jovan. And if they get all three of them at the same time, oh, goodness.
That's a lot of beef.
Yeah, and that's Mama and Daddy Bennett from Hinesville, Georgia. 3 kids playing football on the same team at the same time. Incredible.
3 kids getting a college education, James.
Good throw and catch to Mann. Mann able to get enough for the first down. Chevin Meadows on the tackle. 13-yard throw and catch to Devin Mann.
Quarterback steps back and just lets the ball go immediately. Devin Mann makes the catch and got a couple of yards after the catch as well.
For Rich Freeman and his staff, they got to go back to the drawing board to try to break what in 8 minutes and 35 seconds and counting will be a 2-game losing streak. He called these pride game number 1 and number 2. He lost number 1 to Clark Atlanta last week, and now losing to their oldest rival. Weish breaks a tackle, and then the ball is loose. Mann gets the free ball and gets knocked out of bounds, enough for a first down, and now the ball is bouncing everywhere. 13-yard gain off of the run, the fumble, and the fumble recovery by Mann.
Trevor Wiley came in from the secondary, and Trevor Wiley actually on the carry. DeMario Dixon comes up and lays the shoulder down, knocking the ball out. Put his shoulder pads right on the ball, and the ball popped out.
Some good karma coming the way of the Maroon Tigers. Keeper, Tarver, has some room to run, and eventually he is brought down inside the 40-yard line. Mason on the tackle for Tuskegee. 12-yard run by Jordan Tarver.
I talked about it earlier in the third quarter, how Jordan Tarver continued to give the ball to the running back because he had light and eventually he was going to pull it.
High snap, and fullback will fall on it, Marcus Alford. And now things are definitely not going the way that Coach Freeman would like to see them go. here in the fourth quarter. 15-yard negative for Morehouse, and it doesn't get any easier. At Albany State, which is always tough, at home against Benedict College, then at Fort Valley, who leads the Eastern Division, and then at Kentucky State in November. Could be a very cold and bitter game. Kentucky State, one of the upstart teams in the SIAC.
Miscommunication by the center and the quarterback on the last fumble on missed snap. Tarver was still barking out signals, trying to get everybody lined up, and the center snapped the ball before he called for it.
Second and long. And maybe a half a yard offered on the carry. Aaron Bennett with the one of the good things about the Morehouse Tuskegee Classic is the fact that you do see families and friends out partying together. And obviously we've talked about the Bennett brothers and their family out, but you've seen a lot of Tuskegee family. They're wearing t-shirts with their children's name on the back. Obviously a lot of fans are left the stadium to continue to tailgate and listen to music. There are a lot of activities here in Columbus, Georgia, who have really adopted this game as their own for the past 78 years. Tarver, long throw, incomplete. Cox, the intended receiver, and you see the sea of tents out here in the parking lot of the Columbus Civic Center. They have a wonderful sports complex here. Golden Park, one of the venues for softball during the 1996 Olympics. It is now a minor league baseball park. They have a wonderful, relatively brand new Civic Center, and of course, A.J. McClung Stadium. The fans have been here for the last 2 days tailgating, and I'm just sorry that we couldn't just partake and just say we'll take a breather and eat. But we will be back in a few weeks for the Fountain City Classic, which I hear rivals this one. And a possible fake punt, and he fakes the fake and kicks to make sure that Gardner does not try to return it, and takes a Morehouse bounce, and it is down inside the five with 5 minutes and counting left to play. 51-yard punt by Agoro, 54-10 is your score. Tuskegee with the big lead.
Some moments you spend your life preparing for. Not to prove them wrong, but yourself right. So you work harder, drive stronger, and before you know it, you didn't just beat the game.
Who is that?
Don't know, but he's going places.
You changed it.
Hey, son, ready for the interview?
I got this.
Introducing the 2014 Next Generation Corolla. Toyota, let's go places.
Monday on the series premiere breakdown, right from the rip, Bounce TV is breaking down what's up.
The fro that rocked the New York Mayor's race.
It's like all the Jackson 5 fros combined to one.
With celebrities.
Singer and reality star Ray J.
I have never used a pickup line. I'm lying.
Ooh. Hot gossip.
Kanye West is also hitting the road.
And fresh news.
He wouldn't recognize real racism if he watched the Roots Marathon.
Here we go. It's the series premiere breakdown. Monday at 10:30 p.m. Eastern, 9:30 p.m. Central. Only on Bounce TV our way.
Announce it
today.
How scared are you?
I'm scared.
Own the unrated cut with intense new footage not shown in theaters. Brad Pitt, World War Z. Own it on Blu-ray combo pack today.
Win an entertainment survival package from Philips. A 50-inch HD digital TV with Net TV and Bluetooth soundbar.
Text WWZ to 80412 for your chance to win, sponsored by GQ Menswear, home of the wardrobe upgrade sale. Up to $50 credit towards a new suit October only.
Today's game is brought to you by Gillette. Sensitive skin demands precision equipment. Fusion ProGlide is Gillette's number one razor on sensitive skin. And by Toyota, introducing the all-new 2014 Next Generation Corolla Toyota. Let's go places. And the tailgating will continue out here in Columbus, Georgia. You see, I mean, a lot of people. A lot of tents, a lot of cars, a lot of tricked out cars. We see one right down there with the door up, and a lot of smoke coming from the barbecue pits. Tuskegee back in their end zone. Brickard, the quarterback. And a nice little give. Let's go down to the third member of our broadcast, Doug Stewart, who has a very special guest.
So I'm here on the sideline, and the loudest person over here is Mr. Leland Jones. Now, he has a unique story. Tell everybody your story and your relationship with Morehouse and Tuskegee.
Well, the fact is, I actually attended Morehouse College. However, I've been the chaplain for Tuskegee for the last 2 years. I actually pastor a church in the city of Atlanta.
So do you get invited to homecoming at Morehouse or what?
Maybe I'm there all day long. Man, I tell you what, I'll be honest with you, Tuskegee's our homecoming, it's unspeakable. To be honest with you, what we see here today is beautiful, but you got to come down to Tuskegee to see what real HBCU balling is all about.
Thank you very much. Leland Jones on the sideline, screaming.
Hallelujah for the chaplain. So he's definitely got conflicted loyalties.
But he's got the Lord on his side.
Yes, I would think so.
It's okay.
I would think so. Helmet off for the offensive lineman, which means that he'll have to take a play off the field as the clock continues to run.
That helmet popped up about 10 yards off the field just now.
No doubt about it. Darius Moore, that was the lineman whose helmet went popping off, one of the reserve offensive linemen.
Charles Drinker, the quarterback for Tuskegee. Tackle.
And we're getting a lot of the reserves in. Eric Robinson on the tackle, good form tackle by number two. Ayo Isihola, the running back for Tuskegee. And with 3:30 and counting, it's a punting situation for Morehouse. And you see Coach Slater, not jovial, but not upset.
Right.
He's just thinking.
He's coaching.
And he's coaching him up. Thurston back deep for Morehouse.
Yeah, Derek James punting the ball this time, James. Everybody getting a little work today.
High snap. And not a very good kick. And goes out of bounds. Positive for Morehouse, one of the few positives of the evening. Now, did you know the SIAC is celebrating 100 years of academic and athletic achievement? Let's recognize the accomplishments of Edward Moses and Althea Gibson. Moses was a track star at Morehouse College, won gold medals in the 400-meter hurdles in 1976 and 1984 Olympic Games. He went 10 years without a loss in the hurdle competition. Althea Gibson, one of the greatest female tennis players of all time, became the first African-American to win singles at Wimbledon. She is a member of the Tennis Hall of Fame. Congratulations to these legends of the SIAC.
10 years without losing a track meet. Ten years.
And you know Edwin Moses goes to Morehouse basketball games?
Yes.
And just hangs out? Who would have thought that guy running at Morehouse would be one of the best hurdlers ever? Tarver. Throw. And flag is thrown.
A little aggressive play by the secondary in the end zone.
Intended for Lake McGuffey. Pass defended by Darrell Ward. Marcus Woods has been busy.
Very.
Holding defense, number 40. Half the distance of the goal, automatic. First down.
Coaches will teach you, if you're getting beat in pass coverage, instead of just giving a guy a touchdown, pull on him. Get the flag. Don't let him catch the ball. We'd rather take a 15-yard penalty instead of taking a touchdown in the end zone.
And now the officials making another discussion with 2:48 left to play in this game.
Thank you.
Tarver trying to get the call from the sideline. Give to Alford, fumble on the play, and it looks like it's Tuskegee's football. Yes, it is. Recovery by number 49, Brandon Dorsey, and it looks like that'll be the last song on the playlist for Freeman and for Tuskegee. Celebration can begin.
Very, very physical ball game played by the Tuskegee Golden Tigers. And that's something that Coach Freeman talked about when we spent some time with him yesterday after their walkthrough with Morehouse. This is going to be a physical ball club that they've got to play. And he wanted to make sure that his guys stayed into it mentally and physically, but they just got out physical today by Tuskegee.
Drinker in the shotgun. He will keep and run, has some room to run, and is brought down at about the 15, making the 16-yard line. All the teams in HBCU are playing for the Black College National Championship. Sheraton Broadcast Network Black College Football Top 10 poll. You see Bethune-Cookman on top. Tennessee State, South Carolina State, Winston-Salem State, Division II runner-up last season, North Carolina A&T, Prairie View A&M, and at 9 is Tuskegee, the only SIAC team in the top 10. They play for a mythical title, which is voted on by the media. Once again, they are stacking up the rushing yards. Number 31, Jerome Lewis, just 5'7", 205 from Decatur, Georgia. Lance White on the tackle for Morehouse, and definitely for the seniors and juniors at Morehouse, this is not what you want to see in a second consecutive week.
Yeah, you definitely want to see more when it comes to the performance on the football field on all three phases of the game, special teams, offensively and defensively. You've got to put together a complete package in the three phases, winning two of them, and today Morehouse didn't win one.
First and 10, ball at the 25, and the victory formation for Tuskegee. Time has run out on Morehouse and for Coach and the Golden Tigers. They continue their march toward another SIAC title.
They played an all-around good football game in all three phases today, James.
And now you're starting to see a little smile from Slater. He tried. He tried. But you know what? He says, I'm a real nice guy.
Right.
You know, don't look at my looks. I'm a nice guy. And he really is. Really personable. Loves his players. And another kneel in the victory formation.
Yes, would you stand by for the award presentation at the conclusion of the process?
And time is winding down as Tuskegee once again walks away with the 78th annual Tuskegee-Morehouse Classic Championship. Sportsmanship at the end of the game as both teams will shake hands, both coaches will shake hands. And Ryan, we have seen how dangerous Tuskegee can be.
Really, really strong football team. All three phases, offensively up front and defensively up front. Very aggressive guys, good little pad level. I mean, they just really play good football.
Tuskegee, 54, beats Morehouse 54-10 in the 78th annual Tuskegee Football Classic. Be sure you join us next Saturday, October 19th, 5 o'clock Eastern, for more HBCU football on Bounce. Kentucky State battles Miles College for Miles Homecoming. Coming up next on Bounce TV, it's Bounce Beat. So for Ryan Stewart and Doug Stewart, this is James Barrett saying goodbye from Columbus, Georgia, where Tuskegee wins 54-10. Good afternoon, everybody.
Murphy is showing Robert De Niro Yeah, and if you got any tips from me, feel free. Don't be shy.
Yeah, here's a tip. Stay out of my way and I won't shoot you.
It's not reality TV.
It's showtime.
That's the stupidest thing I ever heard.
It's showtime. Sunday night, 7 Eastern, 6 Central on the New Balance TV Our Way. Johnson C. Smith takes on...